All right, I think we're live. I think I see all the audio things indicating that I'm actually transmitting sound. Hello, everybody. Adam has told me. Oh, also, hi, Elena here, Adam with me. I'm gesturing at my computer screen, even though we're not in the same room, so that doesn't work. Adam tells me there's a lot of people already waiting for this build, so I guess it's time to get started.
Yeah. Thanks, everybody, for showing up on a Wednesday, the day I always call the best day to build a PC. We have a couple super chats or stickers or whatever they are. Thank you, Mike Roylance, and thank you, Just Some Gamer, for tuning in. We are here to build a PC, but first, I'd like to thank today's sponsor, SK Hynix, the maker of the fastest-in-class SSDs. SK Hynix developed the world's first 128-layer NAND-based consumer SSD and is the world's second-largest memory manufacturer. But what really sets them apart are incredible performance at affordable prices, surprising power efficiency, and five-year warranties. In fact, SK Hynix makes PC World's top picks for best all-around SSD and best NVMe SSD. If you want to grab a gold P31 or an S31 on Amazon and give your PC an upgrade, there are links to the description below. With that, let's get going into the build, Elena.
Yeah. I actually wanted to say that I think I saw a deal alert cross my stream this morning for the P31. So if you've been actually waiting to grab one, I think it's on sale right now.
Nice. Love it. Yeah. Good time to do it. For people who are wondering, we have the link to the PC part picker, and even all the scripted, all the parts in the description. So if you're wondering what we're putting in it, look there. Some good parts. I'm excited, and yeah, people are enjoying your nails. People are asking for a BB pre-show, but you know what?
I would love it if you set up a kitty cam. That would be amazing.
I should set up a kitty cam, but BB does not relegate herself to a pre-show. She is the main show.
Oh, that's true. That is true.
But she's also
For the holidays, I think it'd be amazing if we just did a Pets of PC World live stream where we just had pet cam. That'd be great. Sorry, everybody, I forgot to unpack my backpack. So I made a secret, not so secret now, trip to the office to grab some of the things that I had sent there. And I forgot to actually put the backpack down, but I forgot to unpack it. So now you get to see all the goods.
Yeah, those look fancy. Also, I saw in the description these Corsair braided cables. Is that what that is on the right side?
Yep, because I had to rob them from the Viva Las Vegas build.
Oh, got it.
So it's so hard. I was trying to get a small form factor power supply from Corsair specifically because it's just so easy. I didn't have time for with the shipping, time to do a cable mods order. And so Corsair has their basically prepackaged set of braided cables that you can buy, and it's compatible with their modular power supplies, which is pretty cool.
I was trying
to get their small form factor, their 750 platinum, but that's so out of stock. It is incredibly out of stock. I went to Central Computer, which shout out to Central, by the way, because I love shopping there. And this is a sponsored build by SK Hynix, so this has nothing to do with Central Computer asking us to say anything, but I'm just gonna say it. I've been to other places, and me being the gender and the way I present myself, I've had a hard time getting people to take me seriously at other shops. But Central's is super professional. I get in there and they're like, "What are you looking for?" And I'm like, "I'm looking for this B550 motherboard." And they're like, "Oh, okay, let's go look for it." And they're like, "Oh, by the way, you do have a CPU to flash that, right?" And I'm like, "I do." They're like, "Cool." And I'm like, "Thanks, man." Catch you later.
Boom. It's sweet.
No, I love it. They're great. And and the immediacy also is great, because especially with how crazy shipping is. So if you have an awesome local computer shop like that,
give them love.
Spend your money there.
Willis is saying turn down the music if you could, Elena, a bit. And maybe pump your gain up a little bit as well.
Okie dokie.
While that's happening, I realize I can, you know, I need to pull it out from behind me, but I can get one of my webcams set up over the fireplace, because if we want any visual on BB right now,
we do.
It is of her on the fireplace.
I have adjusted the audio. Let me know how that
also
works.
Also, on my camera, I'm seeing a little bit of a bar of Discord visible on the right
side.
Oh,
that's weird. It shifted. Oh, you know what that is? It's because I have the audio menu thing on. <That's why.
laughs> No worries. Just thought I'd point that out.
You guys are seeing the dangers of at-home live streaming. 2020,
love it.
Everybody.
Hey, you know, we do what we can.
So since I have it on the table, I'll just show it to you. So I'm
gonna
be building with these Unifans, and I'm super excited because I've been waiting literal months to finally build with them. Poor Lee and Lee, they're like, "Do you want these?" I was like, "Yes, I do," and then I didn't get to it for like 3 months. But they come in these, so you can get it as a 3-pack, or you can get it as individual fans. And I am gonna be using 6 of these fans, so everything they gave me.
Which we saw at CES, and that's interesting that they come in individual packs. Well, I mean, I guess that makes sense. But
maybe
I mean,
you wouldn't necessarily need 3, right? Like maybe you want a daisy chain, just 2.
Yeah, but the whole idea of the goal of it is to have multiple, easily install multiple fans, in place rather than just get one. Like, do you think it's a good fan just to use as just a single fan? Like if you put it at the rear or something.
No, I mean, like, honestly, the appeal to, well, let's put it this way. I think if you were thinking of upgrading later and, like, adding to it, then you may as well lay that foundation. But if you're just doing a one-off fan, like, at the rear, like you said, that I don't necessarily think you need to spend, like, what, $25 for a single fan? Oh, I almost forget to give myself a pair of scissors or something I can cut things with. Ah! All right, I'll be right back.
You know, people are talking about your shirt. Specifically, Brad wants your shirt.
I love the shirt.
Yeah, and while we're talking about shirts, I need to always remember to mention that the Full Nerd finally has shirts. We've been working on it forever, and now they are here in all their glory. Let me go to the URL because I do not have it memorized yet. I will put it in the chat. If you want to get any Full Nerd shirts, there you go. We have hats that I'm excited about. I'm just going to, let's see. I'll do the trucker hat.
How is my audio level now? Like, is it good? I can barely hear the music.
Oh, yeah.
Can you hear the music?
I have not been listening back. Let me try to listen in. Oh yeah. To me the music sounds good now. So.
Okay, perfect.
Yep. And yeah, if you want any cool merch, we got it.
Oh,
yeah.
I'm still quiet, people are saying. So the problem is that I normally have the mic closer to me, but because I widened the field of view this time, I didn't want like this gigantic just like blob in the corner, but maybe I'll have to just do that anyway.
Yeah, you know, gotta do what we gotta do.
All right,
huh?
Let's try that.
You know, I can back off my microphone a little bit too. I'm loud, probably, especially compared to you. So, I do want to thank everybody who did buy T-shirts and hats and mouse mats so far. Like, I did not expect to sell as much as we already did within the opening days, you know, so that's pretty cool. I'm excited to see what people think, and to rep. Be sure to share it on Discord or Twitter or wherever. I want to see what people think.
I'm not using this, but I just wanted to see the Wraith. I think the stealth that comes with the 5600X.
Oh, the stealth is the slim profile one, right?
I think it is. Like, I was wondering just because, like, this box is much skinnier than previous generations, so. Interesting.
Yeah. I will say my video production PC build, I've yet to install the pure... Oh, God.
Oh,
be
yeah.
Quiet. Pure rock.
The pure.
Black.
Was it Pure? Yeah, I always get their names are a little bit much sometimes, but the Be Quiet cooler.
Yep.
There it is in all its glory.
So yeah, I'm still using the Wraith Prism cooler on the 3800X, and I can definitely hear it when it spins up. I'll tell you what.
Also, if everyone can hear the dog barking again, my neighbors put it out in the backyard again.
Pure Rock 2, thank you, Siv. I appreciate that. And why, Greenbits is asking, why is Elena doing the builds? Well, we've actually been trading back and forth. I took the last build, Elena did this one. We both had one, at least one in November. Actually, no, you had two in November. So you
did
had two
I,
of the console
that
one.
That passed in such a blur. I don't remember anymore.
Yeah, and then I had a 3400G one. So we have some more builds coming up in January as well. So look forward to those. Which actually, I'll say, I was super excited yesterday. I snagged myself a 5800X.
You did. I saw.
Yeah
people...
I was.
Oh, sorry. Go ahead.
I was just gonna say I was in Amazon trying to find links for the listing for this build, because I like to put in the description at least a link to a part if it's available, so that just in case people want to buy it, they can go there. And side note, we do have our own e-commerce tags on it, so if you do end up buying something, we get a little bit of a kickback. I'm not doing it just so we could get the money. I'm doing it to really help people if they're interested in the part. But I was looking for the 5600X on Amazon and it was nowhere to be found, but then I saw the 5800X and it had a hey, you could buy this right now. And I stopped for a minute. I was like, what, really, is this real? And I kind of poked around a little bit and I kind of hemmed and hawed and I was like, I don't know if this is real. What happens if I buy something from Amazon and it doesn't show up? So I put it in my cart. And then I started to check out, and it gave me this weird shipping error, like, hey, we can't ship to your house. And I was like, huh, that's
yeah. Somebody
weird.
In chat just mentioned that.
Yeah,
people are having
and so
trouble
I
with getting shipping to their address.
Yeah, so I actually had it. I selected the
oh
office.
Gosh. I always forget about this glare off the table.
It was able to ship to the office and I was like, okay, cool. So then I clicked through for payment, and then usually there's one more click on Amazon to be like, review the order and see, you know, is everything correct. And when I got to that third spot the first time, it was like, oh, sorry, the product is unavailable. And I was like, ah, crap. I waited too long because I was worried that it wasn't a real legit posting. So I was like, okay, cool, whatever, no big deal. I even posted in Discord. But like, oh man, I was so close to having one. And then I went back in again, I don't know, maybe 15, 20 minutes later, something like that. And to see if there were any other listings for 5600X, because I was looking around and obviously it's not really available anywhere, or at least as of the time yesterday. And I saw that button on the 5800X again. I was like, what the hell? Like, it said I couldn't do it. So at that point, then I was like, okay, I'm just going to breeze through the buying thing. I think I hit that like buy it now button or whatever, just so like you can kind of bypass all the options. And yeah, I got an email saying that it's supposed to come after Christmas, and we'll see. I hope it works out, because yeah. If I do end up getting it in after Christmas, I'll do a build around that. I need to kind of think about exactly what I'm going to do or what I'm going to pair with it. But I was like, dang, I did not expect to snag a 5000 series GPU, which, funny enough, is this 5800X is part of the Full Nerd's best CPUs of 2020. Yeah, congratulations. We had an award stream yesterday on the Full Nerd if you didn't make it, and it was a good time. So yeah. Oh, who is this? Ruru, she's asking, who is the seller of the part? Let me see. I will have to
wait. You didn't buy it direct through Amazon?
I did buy it through Amazon. Yep.
No, I mean, you bought it from Amazon as a seller. You bought it from a third party?
Oh, I think I got it from Amazon. But let me double check, because
oh, no.
I don't want to assume.
Where did I put my keys? There we go.
Oh, nope, that's not it.
Also, somebody asked very early on in the chat if the 5600X would bottleneck the 6800 XT. I feel like for the purpose I'm going to be using this for, it shouldn't be an issue, but I will report back.
Okay. It says sold by Amazon.com Services LLC.
Oh, good.
So,
well, if you got it for street price, it probably is through Amazon because everyone else is trying to scalp.
Yes, it was street price. I did double check. I googled that first time that I saw it appear. I was like, wait, is this the right price? I googled the price. This is street price, so $449, I think is what it was. $449. Yeah. So. Yeah, that's exciting. I'm excited. Oh wow, and I just got a notification in my email saying we sold a t-shirt.
Awesome.
On Design by Humans, so thank you, whoever great. Did that. That's
like,
fun.
So I just want to be clear though that like we don't expect anyone to buy merch from us. Like, it's really actually kind of a strange phenomenon to me because I mean I started as a print editor. And the idea that people are like asking us, they're like, when are you going to get your store up? We're like, oh, ask again in a year, which is actually how long it took us.
It has been a journey. I will say, you know, I'm sorry it is a little disconnected where we have some items on one shop and some items on the other. But so far in the batches of testing, or not testing, samples that we've gotten in, Designed by Humans had the best t-shirts and the best mouse mat options, which I'm actually using right now. I used it for my build, if you want to see it. I used it on my build a couple weeks ago. It was pretty cool. They had the best options there. And then on Spreadshop, they had the best options for totes and hats. I did list aprons, but I did not get any of the aprons in for samples. So I'm not exactly sure how good quality they are, but you know, I thought it'd be put up there something funny. I'll probably buy one just for kicks. But yeah, so the Spreadshop one can link directly to YouTube. That's why I'm able to pin it in the chat. That's why now under some of our videos, I think it'll show up. Where the Design by Humans one, even though it is supported by direct linking to YouTube, YouTube on their back end has been changing some stuff, so I can't right now link to Design by Humans. I need to figure that out on how to link it on YouTube. But so for now, we just have the URL, and you can check it out there. And yes, Matthew Lang, happy birthday. We do have shirts. I did drop a link in. Just in case you missed it, and there it is again. It should be in the description of this post. Let me see. Just to make sure. Yep. Buy the full nerd shirts. Yep. So. Ooh. And another Adam snagged a 5800X too. Look at this. We got a pair of Adams. So, boom. Hitting the 5800X.
Adam, are you keeping an eye on chat? Because I am seeing a bunch of like build related questions that are flying by as we talk about merch. So if you could just pass those on to me, I would like to answer them, but they're going by pretty quick.
Yeah, definitely. Thanks. Thanks for all your good questions. A lot of people love your nails, Elena.
Oh, thanks.
Let's see. LT Ang is wondering if we ever completed the build with the NR200.
Yeah, we did. So when I put together the first Xbox Series X / PlayStation 5 preliminary, I guess I'll call it my foundational build. I used an NR200 for that, so I do have experience building with it. I like it a lot.
I really want to try it too. Are they in stock now? Could I go?
They
out
were
and
for
buy
a
one
bit.
Now?
I haven't looked recently, so I can't tell you.
Also, yeah. Hey, thanks to Brad for being in the chat. Thanks for hanging out, Brad. So always good to have you here.
So, by the way, I saw people asking why I've populated this with the gold P31 down here. I'd like to tell you that I thought about it and somebody gave me an incredible benefit of the doubt. And they're like, did you put it there? Because that's a Gen 3 SSD. And like, you know, it's B550. So only, you know, one of the M.2 slots is going to support Gen 4. No, it's there. And the reason this came out of the box with it on is because I spent last night updating the BIOS on this motherboard. Yep. And it wouldn't post without putting storage in. So I was trying to cheat it. Like, I was trying to go as bare bones as possible. Like, I didn't even have this really in a case at first. And then I realized to plug in the graphics card, I did need to put it kind of in a case so that this, like, the securing part of the bottom of the PCIe slot thing on the graphics card would actually have somewhere to, like, sit. But no, it's there because it was the most accessible and it was the fastest. Because I basically had to build a PC, flash the BIOS, and then tear it back down so that we could do this build today.
Yes. So a little bit of behind the scenes.
So a little behind the scenes there. And I mean, your logic is sound though. So I wasn't actually planning to move it, even though I could.
Well, actually, you know, I mean, but that does make a good point. Yes, this the SK Hynix P31 is a Gen 3 device. The board she has two slots, but one of them, only one of them can be accessed for Gen 4.
And the other reason if you want to do that, other reason I'm putting it down here too is because I like to. I mean, I know there's the heat spreader right there and all that, but I don't usually like to put the M.2 drive right under the GPU if I can help it. So in this case, because I'm not getting a material advantage to putting it in the Gen 4 spot, I'm leaving it there. Nice. Also, before anyone asks, because I did this yesterday, I know which RAM slots I'm supposed to use, and that's why I'm already just putting it in without checking the manual. Normally, I always check the manual.
Yeah, always read the manual. White Zero is asking me what motherboard I plan on using with the 5800X. I have not made any plans yet because I did not expect to get one, so I've not thought about it.
Is this for your personal build or is it for a new production machine?
I haven't even thought about it.
You just bought it, cuz.
Because it's just like, I mean, if I see anything in stock, you know, that is hotly anticipated, I'm like, oh sweet, buy it, and then I'll figure it out later.
Oh, it's like me and that Joby this morning.
Yeah. So I will be using it for a build. Mm-hmm. Yes. Number two, I have not thought about anything past that. Though, White Zero does have a recommendation for an MSI X570 Unity. Though they are a tad slow on the BIOS. So pretty cool.
I for radiators, I actually don't like to mount them until the motherboard's in. So I'm going to wait on this. But I am going to put it together, maybe. Let me think. I brought it out because I wanted to look at it.
Well, while you're thinking about that, so Adam, who also snagged the 5800X, is asking, is it worth keeping over a 5600X? I think we were talking about this a little bit earlier. For pure gaming, you probably won't see a ton of benefit. At least from what I've been able to hear over the 5600X, but also you have that 5800X in hand, where the 5600X is still kind of a hard piece to come by. I think that depends. And I know you say PC gaming is your primary use, but yeah, if you have anything that will use the extra cores, like if you maybe do a little bit of streaming on the side or video editing on the side or anything like that, then you know, those extra cores could come in handy. LT Lang, thank you for the build 101. I know Elena was working a lot to get that BIOS updated so that we could post today.
No, we're not going to post today. That's another thing we should tell everybody. This is part one of the build. So I'm basically going to build this out up until about the point where I'd put in the GPU. Because it just due to scheduling and some other things, we can't go like a full, you know, however long it normally takes me, because I end up chatting with you all and not actually building.
Yeah, well, and I mean, it depends. I mean, because yeah, you have a lot to do. So I mean, let's definitely get a couple hours in, you know, see where we're at, see where a good stopping point is. But yeah, we'll have to pick this up again when the next available time permits. So
not gonna lie. Yeah, so. I'm not always a fan of painting my nails because then I get all weird about like, oh, I just did them. I don't want to damage them. And then like trying to pull things out gets weird because I'm like, ah.
That's funny.
That's one of the reasons why a lot of times I don't paint my nails.
So Cobalt's asking for the RAM specs. We have it in the description if you want to look.
Yeah, so I'm using... So I know the F-clock on this part is like 1900. So it's a little faster than... Or is it that because people are overclocking the F-clocks? I can't remember. I thought the F-clock was actually the same as the 3000 series. So I just pulled whatever I had on hand because we're also a little low on available supplies in the office right now. Mm-hmm. So I'm using 3600 speed, which is fine. I haven't looked too closely into this generation's F-clock stuff. I don't know what the ideal RAM speed is.
Yeah, and it is CL16. Yeah, I have the link in the description.
No, so this one's CL18.
Wanna... Oh, is it? Oh.
Yeah, so it's more common to see 3200 megahertz with CL16 as like your kind of like baseline now. But I bought kind of like a baseline. It's the Ripjaws 5 series from G-Skill. So this one, I think, is a default CL18.
Oh, okay. Well, then I put the wrong listing in.
Oh, did you?
In Amazon. So yeah.
Oh, whoops. No, this is CL18.
Okay. No,
that's it. Builds over. We're all done for. I picked the wrong part.
Picked the wrong part.
Sometimes comments crack me up when people say things like that. All right. I was doing something. Oh, I was removing this.
Yeah. So let me,
but do I want to wait to do this? Because then the backplate's going to come off. Let me actually read the instructions to how to install the Galahad.
Also, welcome everybody over on Discord. I am not ignoring you. Glad to have you all here.
Manly, are you telling me that you did not give me instructions on how to install your cooler?
Uh-oh.
I like to read manuals. Don't do this to me. I'm gonna have to go on their website and look to see if there's a PDF version.
Maybe. And yes, VC Jester, only weirdos hang out in Discord. There's a lot of people hanging out in Discord. And Vignesh, you're right. You know, there you could definitely get hung up on timings and all that stuff for RAM. But you know, I always feel like as long as you get from a reputable source and it's at least, you know. Kind of what the recommended spec is from AMD, then you're good. We're talking about, you know, percentage points, single percentage points of differences here.
I mean, that's kind of what my joke was about, where it's like, yeah, I mean, for that much performance difference, I'm going to shut down this build because I have the wrong RAM now, according to some corners of the internet.
The internet will always internet. And Eskimonster, I missed your message. Hello, glad you're here with us. And Matthew Lang just ordered the shirt. Sweet.
Nice.
Hopefully it comes there before Christmas. We'll see. I'm pretty sure that the Designed by Humans and Spreadshop do deliver internationally. I know prices are probably going to be a little inflated, but... I'm glad at least we have those options for you fine folks who aren't in the US of A. And you know what, Matthew Lang, I can't take any credit for the design. We actually have a designer we work with on our team who kind of oversees all of our consumer brands. He's an awesome guy to work with. He, you know, when we wanted to get this whole project started, we kind of started off with a couple designs. These were the ones we landed on. We have plans for next ones. Definitely Smooth 30 toilet paper launch is on the short list. I think it was VC Jester reminded me yesterday that we'll have we can't forget to have one that says I game at 25x14 because I would love a shirt like that. That would be hilarious. People would look at me and be like, what the hell does that mean?
That would be pretty great. Okay, I found the manual. Oh my gosh. Why is this all the way
And yeah, Gordon is in the chat. He says, is this music from Mario?
You're going to have to play a console game to find out, Gordon.
You're going to have to play a console game to find out. Also, this is not any game soundtrack we are playing.
Are you kidding me?
This is royalty.
I can't view the manual unless I download a zip file, which I can't do on this iPhone that I'm using here. That's ridiculous.
Whoops.
Why would you do this, Leanne Lee? I don't understand.
I
know that I could just figure this out, you know, but I like to read it proper. This is who I am.
Yes, also Carl says that you're using CL18. He just unsubbed from the channel. So.
Yep, I knew it was going to happen. But, you know, I'd rather be honest about who I am.
Blue Collar Tech just joined. Thank you so much for being here. He's asking what case we're using for this build.
I am going to be using the O11 Mini. I'm very excited for this one.
Yeah.
This is going to be a fancy build. I haven't done a fancy build in a while. And also, just I want to prove Gordon wrong that I'm always about the budget end. Although he is the one who loaned me the 5600X, so that was not my choice. I actually asked for the 5800X.
Oh, yep. Well. Yes, this build is definitely gonna be fancy. Clayman's asking how long before Funko Pops of the PC World team. Never. I'm not a huge fan of Funko Pops, though. Though that would be fun. Actually, I would rather have bobbleheads of all of the team. I think that would be really funny.
All right, I'm gonna need to get my laptop, I think, to view this manual. Let me see if I can do it on my other phone.
I can imagine a Gordon bobblehead where he's holding a some coffee, and then you just spring his head, and he's just, you know, yeah.
Or he's holding a U-band container.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Garbage Pail Kids, that's another option. Hey, Zimix is here. What's going on? Also, we have somebody spamming the chat. Nope. No, thank you, sir. So don't do that. Don't do that. There we go. Okay. Boy, oh boy. Yeah. No reason to spam the chat like that. And yeah, that bobblehead would be pretty funny. I would like that. I don't even know what it... How would you... how would you be able to make a bobblehead? Oh, MNAG. Oh, man. I always forget. What is he? Oh, Digi. Digi. What's going on? I definitely pay attention mostly to the YouTube chat. That's where we get most of the people watching. So even though I love having the fine folks over on Twitch, I am not checking it as much. YouTube is definitely the hotter place to be. So
what he's really saying is that he discriminates.
Exactly. When did you start building the PC?
Oh,
well,
I think my cat's trying to break down my door.
Uh-oh. When did you start building the PC? Well, Elena mentioned this earlier. She had to update the BIOS for the Ryzen 5000 series CPU she's going to be putting in there. So she actually kind of did a little bit of the work yesterday and then re-tore it down for what's going on today.
Just keep in mind that if you are buying a motherboard, like a B550 motherboard or X570 motherboard, it is possible you might not need to do a BIOS update. So keep that in mind, and keep in mind if you're going to need to request like a CPU. I think they still have the loaner program where they send you like a low-end CPU that's compatible.
Oh, really?
So you can do an update when you're supposed
that's
to send
cool.
it back.
Huh, that's pretty cool. You know what? I think I've heard about that. That's pretty cool. But you know what you might not have heard of before is SK
Would
Hynix.
Would you zip this?
I do want to take a moment to talk about SK Hynix because they are the sponsor of this build. Really appreciate working with them. They have provided the P31 that you can see is populated in the M.2 slot. Elaine is also going to be putting an S31 in there as well to even further round out the storage options. One of the things that I'd like to note is that the P31 packaging is all biodegradable. Everything about this box is biodegradable. I'm a big fan of that. They are highly reviewed on PC World. You can go check out the reviews. Just search Gold P31 or S31 on Google, definitely good drives. Definitely been great working with them. I'm happy to have a sponsorship for these builds. They sponsor the Full Nerd. We have a couple other videos coming out that are specific to hard drives that'll be coming. So thanks again to SK Hynix for the sponsorship. We really appreciate it. And yeah, Vignesh says AMD still has flash kits available. They send over a super low-end bulldozer APU that you can use to flash. I think
it might not be a bulldozer because, I mean, B550 specifically doesn't support like even with like 3400G APU. So I don't know what their program's like for these newer boards.
Also, Terry, you know, hey, I love your commitment to the hit the F key joke, but I am gonna have to put you on timeout. So. Avix has a question. They're kind of panicking right now. They received their PC 2 days ago, then yesterday when they tried booting it up, it won't start. Nothing was turning on. Do you know what happened? The first couple questions I have for you is, where did you get the PC? Was it a system builder? Was it through a site like Best Buy, something like that? That would be the first question. Second question is, did you defrag the hard drive? Just kidding. No, that was a joke. Joke. But yeah, it is, when you plugged it into the wall and turned on the PSU, did anything light up? Was there anything on the motherboard that lit up? Or are you literally just not getting any power to anything? Nothing's responding at all.
Like, I don't know their situation, and normally I wouldn't say this, but like, if there's a switch on your power supply at the back, make sure it's flipped on, because it's, if you, for example, if you're living with a prankster, like a younger sibling or any sibling, it is possible they're trolling you.
It is definitely possible. And you know what else is possible is maybe a sighting from BB. People are asking for a BB sighting, and I did get my webcam out, but like I've mentioned before, anytime we are close to noon, then she is ready and screaming about lunchtime. So Lindsay brought me her lunch. So maybe I, yeah, come here.
Oh,
come
we need
here.
To watch a live baby feeding.
Oh, see, I'm tricking her brain out, though, because she sees this and she's like, ooh, lunch, but she's running towards the bowl. Nah, you just go and feed her, yeah.
Aww. BB.
Baby, you want some? You want some? Come here. Come on. She doesn't know what to think. What? BB, here. You want some? Come here. Come on up. There she is. There she is. Hi, BB. Ow, BB sighting. BB, look. You want some crunchies? Oh, here's some kitty crunchy ASMR. Let me put a little bit on the desk, move the microphone down, see if we can hear some kitty crunches. She's being a...
Oh, interesting. Okay.
Yeah, she's like gulping it. And she's getting spit all over my mouse pad. All right. All right. BB. Okay, cool. She will be back. She will be back after she eats. She needs a good snuggle. CMC Knight, can we start a donation to get Gordon Ung a controller for Christmas? Well, I mean, you could. First question I have, though, which controller would you get, Gordon?
Ouya.
yeah, I don't know. I will tell
Find
you.
Find an old been... Ouya for him. All right. Okay. This is my AM4 bracket. Oh, you can't see that. Sorry. This is my AM4 bracket. I now know what I'm doing with this, and I'm going to put it away as I pull out the O11. I'm moving on. I'm going to...
I do want to give a little shout out. Razer did send over a Wolverine V2 that I've been using lately. This is primarily designed for the Xbox, but it does have Windows drivers and works has full compatibility on Windows, so that's where I'm using it. It is a little bit more, kind of an entry level controller. It's wired. There's only two customizable triggers, and they're actually on the shoulder position rather than the backside. But if you like tactile buttons, because this actually does have a really good kind of a tactile feel on the face buttons. I don't know if you can hear it or not. But yeah, I know there's a lot of people, like a friend of the show, Keith from WCCF Tech, actually loves his Wolverine V1. I think he has like the tournament edition or something. I can't remember. There's a couple different Wolverine versions out there.
Oh, here's the manual.
But I have been trying it out. It's not bad on the PC, but I don't know if this is what I would start Gordon out on. It's a good question. And yeah, I thank you for the answer, Avix. I think Brad has some good points there. Also, I'll say at least Digital Storm. I mean, that is a really nice manufacturer that you bought from. They are probably more than willing to help out immediately.
Oh, if he bought from Digital, or they, I don't know the gender, sorry. If they bought from Digital Storm, you've paid enough money for excellent customer service, my friend.
Yeah,
call them
yeah,
up.
So
they will take care of you.
Definitely take advantage of it. And also, Vignesh, great point. Gordon is now worthy of being a mod on this channel, so I gave him mod rights. Gordon,
here we go. Banhammer coming for everybody.
I know. He's going to ban everyone that talks about consoles and
or the M1 chip.
And BB's back. Hi, BB.
All right. I don't know if y'all can't see this, but I'm really hoping I can actually fit the O11 on this desk. So unfortunately, one of the constraints about working from doing these live streams from home is that I don't have as much space to like spread out. So you may only end up seeing like one corner of the case as I'm working in it. So let's see how this goes.
Well, we'll see. Yeah. Also, John's asking, John Scheige is asking, is this a Silent Night build? This should be pretty silent, right?
Oh, no. I mean, with that many fans, I mean, the tempered glass will probably muffle some of it, but I don't think it's going to be like a silent build. But that, if we weren't on holiday break, would be a great New Year's.
And the Cobra was the lucky winner of the headset that I did the giveaway, the quick giveaway over. I think it was the Black Friday. I'm glad they got it in. That's awesome. I definitely have more giveaways planned in the new year for sure. So yeah, and PJ's asking for Gordon to ban them. I think it would be an honor.
Let's see.
And yeah, Captain Cosmic, you know, it the stock issues are definitely a thing. That's why we dubbed the worst trend of 2020 toilet paper launches.
I mean, so I should say, like, shout out to all the companies that, you know, helped us out with this build, you know, by sending us stuff, partially early in the year, partially, like the AIO was me saying, like, hey, I'm going to be doing a lot of Lee stuff in this build. You want to just make this an AMD, you know, cross Leanne Lee build? They're like, sure, we'll send you one out right away. I was like, oh, thanks, guys.
There you go.
Gordon lent me one of his review samples so that I could actually get my hands on a Ryzen 5000 part. Same with Brad and the 6800 XT.
Sanchez MTZ44 says their Elite controller had a bad stick drift after a few weeks. I'll tell you, so I have I had both the Elite Series 1 and the Series 2. I actually haven't had any problems with them, not even like the peeling grippy on the Series 1 that I know some people had problems with. But the our coworker Luis actually went through three Elite Series 2s.
Did he throw them?
No, they came bad out of the box. He was actually really upset. He's a big Xbox fanboy, and even he was just like, dude, this is not cool. He was pretty bummed out by the problems he was having on it, but he still ended up, you know, continuing until he got one. And Dean doing a great job. He says doing a great job over the year and much appreciated. Thank you so much. Budget quality balance parts are much appreciated. Those conversations allowed me to share the joy of PC building with their niece. That's awesome. Yeah. I love sharing the joy of PC building. You know, we've done what we can, hopefully on YouTube during this this lockdown period. But man, I do miss being in the office and being in a studio.
How is your niece or nephew's build gone? Like, is he enjoying it?
Yeah. I haven't had a chance to walk through how to change settings in a PC game yet. So I think he just fires up the game at this point, and whatever settings it auto-populated with, he's playing it. So I need to kind of walk him through, like, hey, this is a resolution. This is how you change that. This is how you, do certain things. Other than that, he fired it up. The first game he played was Grounded. He was very excited about Grounded. He's digging it.
Well, the camera doesn't like focusing on that. Oh, there we go. All right, so that is, I just need to take this apart a little bit and then we'll fly this flat.
Brad says he's using a cheap $30 Xbox One controller from Power A. Actually, I have heard good things about Power A. I think Luis has bought some Power A controllers for his family members. I have an embarrassing amount of controllers in my place because I actually do want to revisit the best controller for the PC video that I did a couple years ago, I guess now. Matthew Lang, $5. Thank you so much. Always appreciated. Said time to order food. This build is going quick. Well, it's going quick now, but you know, this build is definitely all about making it pretty and taking the time to make things pretty. So
we're nowhere near done. Trying to do, my friends. I can zoom out a little bit because I did zoom in for the motherboard.
And PJ says, damn, it's a large case. I mean, it's not.
I just don't have much room on this set at all.
Yeah, it's not like a small
scale,
form factor case.
This is my hand. This is let's see, here's a screwdriver. Like, it is not a large case at all.
Yeah, not a large case. Definitely roomy.
Oh my goodness, cat!
Also, a good little case. I like it. I did get to see it in the flesh when last time I went into the office.
Wait! Don't jump on the motherboard! Don't jump on the motherboard!
Does Xbox One have a stick curve control on the PC? Yes, I believe there is a utility to change all that. Well, I know there is for the Elite controllers. I don't know if it works for the standard controllers. That is a good question, actually. I know, and Ziv, you're right. Matthew Lang is such a generous guy. He's always giving money on his birthday. We should be giving him money on his birthday.
Oh, no. I just realized I don't have the right tool to take off these standoffs with me. I don't have that in my kit. Oh no! It's in the office kit.
Oh no.
Alright. Hold up, everybody. I'll be right back.
Yeah, not a problem. I'm waiting to see if BB pulls up in front of the fireplace again, then I'll set up the kitty cam. OK2Go, yeah, you are new to this channel, but thank you for watching all these builds. It's always fun. These builds are always a good way to hang out, have some fun, learn about. Oh, and there's Elena's sign. Totally forgot about the sign. It's a good sign. The full nerd. It's always fun, and I still am always very honored to be on the Full Nerd with such intelligent people that I get to work with. So I'm happy with that. Game streams are fun. You know, I wish we could do more pre-recorded content like we used to before the whole work from home situation, but we try to do as much as we can. Thank you for everyone for bearing with us through these times. So, and Lian Li, I have never built, me personally, I've never built in a Lian Li case, so I'd be curious to try it again. Try one out for the first time. There hasn't been any that have really, like, kind of stuck with me. Like, ooh, I should really try this one other than this 011B Mini. But also it's kind of bigger than what I would want a mini case to be. I'm personally not going to do a ton of water cooling and stuff like that. So, and yes, Elena forgot her Swiss Army knife. She did not come prepared. Mac Drew, the headphones I'm using are the E-MU Teak. So E-MU-TEAK. Really nice higher end consumer headphones. I do use them for my professional mixing with my Sound Blaster X3 because these are actually really comfortable. It's got a leather padding and it just, oh man, yeah. Comfort is definitely the name of the game when I'm sitting here at work and having to always wear headphones 24/7. I definitely wear more headphones now than I did when I was in the office. Let's see, more questions. Denon headphones. I know there are some Denon headphones that kind of look like this, but no, these are EMU Teaks. And Rick, yeah, you know, that's, yeah, I do feel like we've always had great chemistry because I feel like we have a good team, a well-rounded team with different viewpoints. We all come from different angles, and that's why I love working with the full nerd team. That's for damn sure. Couch King is asking, is Digital Storm good for the price? I can say, it depends on what you are looking for. We have had a number of completely pre-built custom systems sent in, Digital Storm, Falcon Northwest, and a lot of those we've used on the set for when we're in the studio. They're, at least in my experience, the ones I've checked out have been really well made, really nice pieces put together with some cool custom jobs on it. So even though I wouldn't necessarily buy a pre-built, because I do like putting together my own PC, I think it is worth at least looking into. CSGO Smokes, the 011D Mini is in a weird spot. You're right, definitely. But I think the options that it does offer are unique and good for people who could use it. That's why I'm actually glad Elena's doing a build in this, because this is definitely a Elena style build. Definitely. Let's see, is there actually a performance difference between the 3070 and the 6800? That is definitely a Brad question. I think he's still on the chat, maybe he could answer that. Joss Bond, what do we think about the 3090 and the 6900 XT? I'll say, you know, those are definitely aimed at the bleeding high end people. Whether you just want the nicest card that is available out there and money is no object, but also for certain content creators that can take advantage of large GPUs like that. For me, it's way overkill. I don't think it's worth it. I did vote for the RTX 3080 to be the best GPU of 2020 on our show yesterday. But yeah.
All right.
Welcome back.
I don't have any crescent wrenches, but I was able to bum this pair of pliers off of one of my housemates.
There you go. Yeah.
But I'm going to
have to do what you can do.
Buy my own crescent wrench or, you know, an iFixit tool set.
Yeah. AE Deox is asking, where can I get a free PC? That is a great question. One that I don't know if I can answer. Neko-chan, the thoughts between the Sound Blaster G6 and the X3. So the G6, let me Google it real quick. If I remember correctly, G6. Yes, I did get a G6 in for testing. I was doing kind of a roundup between the G6, whatever the Sennheiser, God, I think it's the GSP No, that's the headphones. There was a Sennheiser USB DAC that I had looked at as well. I can't remember. Yeah, I mean, night and day, I would pick the X3 over the G6, mostly for the Super XFi. The G6 is not a bad DAC if it's a good price, but it is a little bit on the older end. The design is not as user friendly, I think, personally, me as the X3. So I guess it depends on the price, but if you, if it's price for price, then I would definitely not pick the G6. But then again, that said, anything's better than motherboard audio for my taste. Let's see. I'm not seeing a price on their site. Oh no. Oh, so it's 160 with a promo 140. Nope. Sorry, I am not quite sure why Creative is pricing it at that point, because yeah, everything that they're offering in that is also present in the X3, and in the X3 you get Super XFi. So yeah, I would pick the X3 over the G6. Easy. Let's see, talk about custom PC manufacturers. Talking about, okay, VC Gesture said someone suggested that the screwdriver with a bit removed will work on the standoffs.
I don't have anything.
Yeah.
Like, honestly, I don't really have much at all with me. I need to get a proper tool set. I've been a lazy renter.
OK2Go has a good question. Have you done any streams where you upgrade a cheap pre-built? That is on my list for ideas. I know there was chat about getting an old Dell Optiplex, making
yes.
that, you know, throwing a card in that and using it as a PC, a gaming PC. I'd like to. I actually think it's kind of a cool idea. I would need to look more into it, but I think I've heard enough people say that at the low end, if you're looking for a cheap gaming PC, that is definitely something to do. So I don't know, but there's part of me though, and obviously I haven't done, but part of me is though, like the idea of getting a cheap Optiplex that's obviously some sort of workstation thing. My worry is like I'd open it up and it'd be like just cobwebs everywhere and Cheeto dust, like coming from somebody who had used it, and that's probably just way off, but the GSX 1000, yes, that was it, which actually I did like before the X3 came out. I really did like the GSX 1000. That was a really good DAC, and even though the audio processing wasn't up to snuff with the Super XFi, it was the one that I tested that got the closest in terms of a fake surround sound processing. So that is a pretty cool one. If you can get a GSX 1000, I actually don't think they make them anymore, but those are something to look at too. If it's cheaper than the X3, then I think it's worth a look, but if it's the same price or more expensive, I would just do the X3, to tell you the truth.
Motherboard standoffs are never going to be the same.
Clayman says he recommends bolt cutters.
Bolt cutters for what? I don't want to get rid of these.
Cut them right off.
Yeah, that's really going to help me finish this build. Yeah, I don't have an iFixit set, so I'll show you all what I bought. Which incidentally, I think I actually got a Central Computer like 6 years ago. But I don't have anything that would help with the standoff. At least not that I can see from first glance.
Sounds like Sennheiser actually does still sell. Oh. Okay, yeah, you can. Okay, you can still get it on the ePost audio. Ooh, for 230. Ah. It's a good deck. It is a really good deck. I did like my time with it. For 230 though, it's a little bit on the older. Doesn't have that super X-Fi. That's a hard one. That price, yeah, I don't know if I would pay that price over the X3 to tell you the truth.
Rest in peace, beautifully painted. Oh, I don't know if I can get this to focus. It's just like the vice, I think these are called vice grips. This thing is just like tearing the paint job all to heck.
Oh no.
Maybe I have a rubber band.
What you gotta do.
Well, I've done most of them, but yeah, I'll get a rubber band. I'll be right back again.
No problem. And yes, we do have the Gamers Nexus toolkit. Steve was nice enough to actually, no, I think we bought one of those. Yeah, we bought the unsigned one, and then we were gonna, next time we would see him at an event, try to get it signed for the cheaper price and be like, ha, see, we didn't pay for the signed ones. Ha. I love Steve, just making a joke here. No, I love my Leatherman. I'll tell you, Gordon is the person who sold me on buying a Leatherman, and I use it pretty much every day. I love the Leatherman. You know, and Ziv, yes, these streams, you know, we try to, depending on the time frame, how long we're going to do it. This is a little bit different because we will be doing a second part, so I think we'll... You know, we'll see where a good stopping point is, but we're not going to be going 3 hours in this one, probably. We'll go as much as we can.
Don't jinx it.
And then, yeah.
It's like...
Well, I mean, we can stop wherever, you know, and then pick it up in the next part. So, yeah. So, CSGO Smokes, which Sennheiser gaming headset are you using? I've used a couple of theirs. I think it was the... it was the open back version of their high-end gaming headset. I did like it. The fit was a little weird on my head. The clamping was a little tight. I also don't remember the microphone quality being super amazing, but I did like that it was an open back gaming headset. I feel like there's not enough open back gaming headsets out there. So I guess it depends on what you're plugging it into, but if you're hearing motherboard audio noise, if you're hearing any sort of interference, then yeah, I would definitely look into getting a DAC for those situations. Yeah, and Gordon's talking about his love for pocket knives. I'll tell you what, he's got a lot of pocket knives. You might not know this, but Gordon has an extensive flashlight collection too. He's very well knowledgeable in LED flashlights. So I'm sure if you want to talk to him about flashlights,
I'm gonna be able to save the paint on this. I'm just gonna have to.
You know, I should look it up. There's an old episode of Hardcore Hardware where he actually reviewed a flashlight. Gordon, can you remember what that flashlight was? That was a good video. Oh, there we go. It's the Phoenix RC40. Gordon called it the ultimate flashlight. I'm gonna drop it in the chat real quick. That was a fun video to make. We actually went to where I live now, Alameda, to film the outdoor
tape.
Parts.
I didn't think of that.
That was pretty fun.
Well.
Should review the PC37X and the PC38X. Let me look those up.
So I think
spotted
somebody in chat saying that this is really silly. I don't disagree, but the thing is that not everybody is well equipped in terms of tools, and I'm spoiled. I'm used to the office having everything I need, and I forgot that I was gonna have to mess with motherboard standoffs today. And now I'm paying the price for that with this very slow, laborious process. Although I did actually recommend something similar to somebody the other day, because they had that classic problem where they didn't tighten down their standoff enough, and now it's just they're trying to remove the motherboard and the screw is just spinning in place. And I was like,
oh,
well,
no.
If you have a thin set of pliers or
That would suck.
I mean, the best is a small crescent wrench. But if you only have a pair of pliers, I hope you have a good grip. Good luck.
Gotta do what you gotta do.
Yep.
So I am looking at these Sennheiser
PC37X.
Those are open back. They're pretty cool. And then on Amazon here, they do have the listing for the GSP 500, the open back headset. Those were the ones that I was using for a bit too. I would love to do more reviews of headsets and stuff like that. There's only so much time in the day. Oh my God. So many things I wish I could do.
Why the heck am I pulling out all the motherboard standoffs, you ask? Well, that's because the O11 is a modular, I guess you can call it, PC case, in that you can have it support a ATX layout, a micro ATX layout, or a mini ATX layout. And right now it is, last partial build I did in this was for ATX, and so all the standoffs are in the wrong position for this micro ATX board that I have, because I wanted to show you all, not even to show you, I wanted to do a micro ATX build in this case. Like, to me, that's the sweet spot for the amount of space I have. I think it looks a little cavernous with the mini ATX if you're not actually populating it with radiators as well. Mm-hmm. And I don't have as much clearance, and I'm not planning to use all the PCIe slots on a full ATX board, so we're going this way.
Nice. So speaking of tools, I have my Leatherman Wave here. That's my go-to.
Oh, Halosing Jenkins, is that true? Let me go look at my accessories box.
So yeah, but I have a drink here that I actually want to test out. I ended up getting this yesterday. This is there's a local brewery here in Petaluma, California, North Bay, called Lagunitas, and I noticed they actually make a non-alcoholic seltzer. They call this the Hoppy Refresher. I saw this and I was like, okay, cool. Lagunitas is a good brand. I want to check it out. So I'm gonna crack this open. If I can get the right tool, wrong one, and try it out. It should be fun.
Also, Adam, if you could feed me the chat stuff again, don't get me wrong, it's great when we are chatting, but it is helpful for me to actually be able to keep up with chat because you're able to feed it to me.
Yeah, not a problem. There's a lot of side discussions going on, so nothing specific yet.
Well, no, I am catching, like, the fact that I actually just got a good tip from somebody is because I happened to glance up at the screen at the right time.
Cool. All right. Yep. I will feed them to you as they come in. But yeah, this first taste of the Lagunitas Hoppy.
Oh, yes. I totally forgot about this. Thank you. Well, now you know how I used to roll back in the day.
Yes, and that's where Leo Laporte's the studios are. Actually been to the old studios. And you know what? This is actually pretty damn good. Lindsay, you want to try this? Lagunitas makes Newcastle in the US market now instead of shipping from the UK. Huh, that's cool. Yeah, it's actually a little sweet. A little sweeter than I thought it'd be, but... yeah. I like it. So, Halestine, and yeah, Halestine, thank you so much for that tip. That's awesome. Let's see if that worked out better.
It's hilarious, because I actually have done this before. You would think I remember, but it's been a very long fall, everybody. All right, and now I'm back in the game.
And let me check over on Twitch. I haven't checked on Twitch for a bit.
But also, nice. If you happen to be somebody who doesn't have these tools, and for some reason you're using a case that doesn't come with this, well, now you know the old school Elena way of dealing with this problem. It ain't pretty,
sweet.
But it fixes it.
Joel is enjoying a hot chocolate watching us right now. That's
favorite winter beverage. Cool. Excellent choice.
Kind of the opposite end of a Lagunitas hop. Charlie B's asking, are you wearing that Livestrong bracelet to fight static, Alina?
Are you talking to me?
Yes.
I didn't quite catch the question, sorry.
Too much. Are you wearing a Livestrong bracelet to fight static? It's mostly a joke.
Well, I wasn't sure if it was a joke because a lot of people do mistake this Fitbit for that.
Gordon says he's been drinking a lot of James Younger whiskey lately. The reviews called it horrible. Tastes like it was fermented in an old leather boot. Great. King is asking, why are you building this PC with all AMD parts, Elena?
So the reason why is that I wanted, so a couple reasons is that, one, I wanted to see what it's like to mess around with smart access memory, that feature. And two, I also wanted to see what the experience is like with the newer cards. And this allows me to do both. Sorry, I'm just trying to figure out which standoffs I actually need for this board. 1, 2, 3.
And Optimum Slinky says, why not? Why not?
There's also that, the why not factor.
Also, I mean, this is the first time we're building with anything Ryzen 5000 related and Radeon RX 6000 related. So that's always a good reason to do it too. Check out the new parts. It's a little sweet, right? Yeah. Cool that they're making it. Rick Elder tried a nice whiskey a few weeks ago. Midwinter's Nights has a slight spicy finish. I like that. Oh yeah, it is kind of florally, huh?
And yeah, it's good. I forgot the DEJ915. I just said that that's very true. That's a good point. So if you are buying your motherboard from a local store, like I guess Micro Center, or I didn't ask Central if they did it as a service. But some local computer stores will do a BIOS update for you for free, or for a fee, but they'll do it for you. And I gotta say, after spending like, I don't wanna say 2 hours on this process, 2.5, because I had to build, flash, and then tear down. if your time is worth your money, then it could be worth it if you have to pay. Mm-hmm, all right, mm-hmm. Let's see.
Bryant also did a full AMD build. Awesome. I wanted to go AMD, but I was scared because all my friends said it's hard to install it and things like that, so I used a 8700K. Still good. I will say, so what was it? The 3400G was the first AMD CPU that I installed. On my next stream, I installed this 3800X. When the motherboards that I got already had those AMD standoffs and I was using the included cooler. Oh, no, the first one wasn't the included cooler, was it? The 3400G? Ah, God, no, what did I put on that? I can't remember.
3400G?
Anyway, having those...
3400G, I thought you used the stock cooler.
Yeah, wasn't it? Yeah. I thought so, yeah. Either way, I don't think it's necessarily easier or harder than Intel. I mean, I think it just depends on the cooler you use. The CPU itself install was...
Merlino, you keep saying things like that, but the thing is that if I have to build a PC or build it up and then tear it back down, it is going to take me a little bit of time. So, I mean, congratulations if you're faster, but, you know, everyone who comes on these streams is always saying that, so... If you want to be fast, that's great, but we're here to be chill.
Yeah, and Paul, I'm glad you're here and all, but if you're gonna have those snotty little comments, then why don't you go watch something else instead? Let's see. No AMD PCU, too bad for the fanboys. It's true. Joel's asking, is the bottom right standoff in?
This is not necessary for this board.
Oh, okay. Bryant went with the 3600 XT. Nice. Yeah, I think the Ryzen 3000 series, definitely easier to get them than the 5000 series, at least, hopefully. Oh yeah, 8,700K. That's not bad. That's not bad at all. Neko-chan, what do you think about premium boards? Are they worth spending that much for a X570 Strix versus the X570 Dark Hero versus the X570 Asus ROG Maximus?
I would say that it's really dependent on how much overclocking and like features like Wi-Fi and built-in Wi-Fi and Bluetooth matter to you, and then also RGB, because those are really the primary things you're going to get the more you spend on those motherboards. So it's just really determining what your preferences are. And then you also get like nice things like I don't know if you could see on this particular motherboard, but the IO shield is built in, so like that saves you, I don't know, 2 minutes, but the amount of irritation, it could be worth it to you, you know. Those little things.
And it's funny, I always forget that the that motherboards don't come with Wi-Fi for some reason. I mean, I'm always somebody who uses a wired connection, so for some reason in my mind I just assume all motherboards come with Wi-Fi. But yeah, that's definitely something to look at as a nice little bonus, if you want to use it. And Chips has been watching for about 6 months. Great builds, keep it on. Thank you so much. Glad you're here with us, hanging out. It's awesome. CMC Knight says maybe we should have a half nerd shirt where that says Elena is faster than you, and has a pizza slice on the back. That would be pretty funny.
I am very quick at eating pizza slices. That is a good point.
Exactly. I like it. Let's see. King's asking, will this PC be only for gaming?
For my purposes with it and the short time I'll have with it, yeah. Yeah. Because I'll have to tear it down to give the CPU back to Gordon.
Got it. And PJ, thank you for showing up. They have to run. Always good to have you here. Dark Templar says, a little salty, the Dark Hero exists. I have a normal X570 non-hero. And yes, Enzo, good point. We're here just to hang out and have some fun. This isn't a video game speedrun. Definitely. Let's see. Vignesh says, I never have to worry about my IO shield with my open air case. Yeah, there you go. Don't put it on. Then you don't have to worry about it. We have a new PC builder, a Badot guy. Badot guy? Says, yesterday I built my first PC with a Ryzen 5 3600. Nice. Welcome to the club. Let us know if it posted, if it all went well. That's awesome. Glad to hear you joining the PC world.
There's nothing like that feeling of first post.
Yeah, I know, right? Gordon's talking about the merits of a high-end motherboard. Yeah, definitely.
And Rick Elder, I do plan to grab that. I'm shocked that they're giving away so many like really high-profile games. And if you don't know, by the way, if you're listening, you don't know what I'm talking about. So Epic Game Store is going to be giving away free games starting tomorrow. Tomorrow's the 17th? Yeah. So starting tomorrow, they're going to be giving away a free game every day, I think until the end of the month. And this is pretty good.
Matthew Lang has a good t-shirt idea. The half nerd, same great content, half the calories. That's pretty funny. And then King, yes, I will say you can use a Radeon card for streaming, you can use it for content creation, but NVIDIA with their CUDA is definitely a better choice if you're going to go with streaming, and most content creation can make use of that as well. So, oh, and Brad says he has to split. Looking forward to seeing the final build. Thank you, Brad, for hanging out with us.
Yeah. That's awesome. It's kind of cool to have a full nerd actual attendance.
Yeah. I miss having Gordon in on the streams.
I do too. Although I would not let him anywhere near this with a beer can. Sorry, Gordon.
And Dennis, 2020 is almost over, and I've managed to watch zero Babylon 5 episodes.
Yeah, Adam. So. We're going to have to get on. We'll probably have to do that next in the spring, or at least late winter.
Yeah. Is a Manos is asking, is a Ryzen 3 3100 and an RTX 550 good for Fortnite? An RTX 550, I don't know what that is. I think that might be a mistype.
Well, I mean, how are they defining good for Fortnite though, right? Like, do you want a certain like frame rate? Do you want to play at a certain resolution? Because Fortnite will run on a potato, if I recall right, so.
Yeah, you know, though Fortnite is surprisingly, does take up a surprising amount of more power than I thought it would, to tell you the truth.
Start putting the fans in.
If you can clarify the GPU for me. Bryant's asking, is that board a 570 or 550? Oh, I'm sorry. No, not the board.
My
I think he's
board?
Talking about RX 570. Okay, for the GPU. Yeah, RX 550 is not a thing. RTX 550 is not a thing.
All right, it's fan time.
Fan time, fan time. Let's see. Yeah, you don't need much for Fortnite, but. Yeah, actually, I did get to play a little bit of Fortnite on the 3400G when I did that build, and was actually able to get a good 10. I believe it was 1080p medium, and I got a good solid 30 on that. Yes. EVGA had a sale for 360 AIOs for $100. AMD Ryzen 5 3600 and an Asus 1650 Super, good for gaming. Yeah, you can definitely game 1080p with a 1650 Super. Depends the game, depends what the frame rate you're trying to hit, but you can definitely do that. Let's see. Oh yeah, White Zero brings up something good that I was talking with Gordon about. At CES, we got to talk with an engineer, a thermal engineer on the Ice Giant Pro Siphon.
Oh, is that out yet?
Cool. It is out, and I think we should do a follow up, Gordon, because that would be super cool. It was fun to hear from an engineer like that. King is asking, is a 1080 Ti better than a 2060 Super? You know what? I'm going to leave that one to Gordon. Gordon, what do you think? 1080 Ti better than a 2060 Super? Being the case with the PCU on top seems so 6 years ago. Well, not only is the PSU at the top, it's also kind of hidden behind the motherboard in an interesting way. I kind of like the layout of this. But you have to use a small form factor PSU for this one. Yeah, a follow-up video would be cool for the pro, right. The Ice Giant.
Would y'all like to see the Unifans?
Unifans.
Let's see if I can do this without. I really hope Keith isn't watching because he saw it the first time. Adam knows what I'm talking about. So yep. The way this works is that you can daisy chain these fans and run them off a single set of wires, which is amazing. So you basically let's see if I can do this right. You slide them together.
No cables.
Sorry. So you put them together, you slide them, and you lock it in place, which I'm going to have to do off camera because I can't get the leverage I need. There we go. So now they're connected. And as you can see, so like those connectors right there. And then what you do is you take a set of cables and you attach it to an end. How do I want to do this? How does this work?
Raskin Carbon is asking, how much are those fans?
Individually, I think I've been seeing them around like 25. That might be the sale price. I haven't been keeping like super great attention to it. Hold on, I actually should look at the manual for this one because I didn't actually do this at CES. I only slid them together.
And Anthony, not only can you do two fans on one cable, you can actually do three fans
up
on
to
one
four.
Cable.
Up to four.
Up to four?
Up to four. So you can do like 480.
Damn.
I don't think these are static pressure fans though. So I don't know if you'd want to use them with a 480 rad, but don't quote me on that because I haven't looked at the stats on it.
King, is it true that a spinning platter hard drive can slow down your PC? Funny enough, we actually, Gordon and I are working on a video on that right now.
Oh, silly me. He goes on this end. All right, so.
Yes, the benefits you can get from switching to a physical hard drive to an SSD are immense. It's definitely, you will feel that it's probably one of the easiest upgrades you could do to speed up your PC is to install things on a SSD, especially the OS.
This goes into here, and then you just slide it forward, which I'm gonna have to do off camera because I can't get the leverage I need. There you go.
And Battle Venom, when do you expect prices for PC parts to drop down? Probably not anytime soon. Because it's not just inflated by the holiday rush. A lot of people are working from home. A lot of people are looking for PC gear. A lot of people are looking for gaming PC stuff. So, yeah.
If you're interested in these fans, I think I saw a chat message fly by saying that they are interested in these. I think it's Inwin. I think it's their Saturn line. Maybe it's a Jupiter, I forget. They always use like planetary names. They have a set of daisy chaining fans as well. And their system is not quite as elegant, in my opinion, as this, where it's like interlocks and it's like just a super clean look. But they at least allow you to have the fans together and there's like just shorter like loops that connects the fans. And then you'd have like the one that rads off. But I don't know, they might be cheaper. So if you don't mind mixing your companies, then you know, you could always get the Galahad AIO, and then you could do the Inwin fans, or you could just, I guess, I don't know, wait. Alright, so how do I want to wrap this? I think I want it to go this way. Yeah. Big ol' headshot. Let's route some fans, cables.
Rupunjan is asking about a i5 10400F or a Ryzen 5 3600 to pair with a 3060 Ti. I need 1080p, I need FPS in Warzone, PUBG, Battlefield 5 at 150 frames per second plus on stream constant. Oh boy, wow.
Wait, what were the two choices?
The 10400F or the 3600 paired with a 3060 Ti.
And what's their priorities?
First person games while they're streaming, 1080p, 150 frames a second plus.
Are they looking to stream off that box?
They don't say.
It doesn't seem like. It doesn't seem like it, they would, right?
No, I wouldn't expect that. I mean, though, at 1080p, if you're just a 3060 Ti with 1080p, it's got overhead to kill. You could.
Yeah, I would just say that, like, honestly, at this point, it's whatever you can get your hands on.
Probably the Intel part.
Do I want an intake or do I want it?
I don't know.
Yeah, I probably should take. Well, oh my god. Hold up.
64-bit goodness says you may want to flip the fans.
Yeah, I mean,
I've not been paying attention.
No, I mean, they have a point, because it's like, I mean, I could do, like, exhaust straight up this way. I'm trying to think. Yeah, I guess I'll flip them. I would say that unless that person has, like, really firm plans to upgrade to, like, a more powerful Ryzen processor, then it doesn't really matter. Like, you just at this, like, I mean, it matters, but realistically speaking, given how hard it is to get your hands on, like, the 3600 in particular, then, you know, go with what's available. But I would say if you want, like, an upgrade path, like a wider upgrade path, then Ryzen's going to be a better bet for that. And it's hard. It's just like the availability right now.
Right. Yeah. Well, and to tell you the truth, I mean, a 10400F probably isn't super easy to get.
Intel parts are a little easier to get right now.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, I see it on Newegg. The price is 163.
I'll go there.
I don't think that's an inflated price, right? So, yeah. I wonder what the upgrade path is for this. Like, how high you could go.
Wait, do I want to ride it that way? Or do I want to try to route it that way?
Vignesh says, I found the perfect circular back labels the other day to put on the back of PC fans to cover up the ugly manufacturer label that's usually there. Oh, that's cool. Like that. And Antoning Unifex says, how do you want your airflow to pull, push in this case? Elena, what are you thinking?
I think what I'm going to do is because I don't have, so this is tempered glass on the front here, so I don't have like a clear path going this way. So what I'm going to do is go this way instead, and then I'll still see if I can put a rear exhaust fan for funsies right there.
King's asking about the Intel Xe GPUs. Well, they are in laptops. There are some options out there. Gordon's definitely the better person to ask for that stuff, but we have not really seen any desktop consumer Xe GPUs, and really don't know too much about where they're aiming, where they're trying to fall in line. Is it going to have hardware ray tracing support? And Thiazide? God, I don't know how to say that, sorry. They wish their 6900 XT got here on launch day would show up already. FedEx really dropped the ball on delivery. Sorry about that. That really sucks. That really sucks. Let's see.
Also, this is why headlamps are a really great investment. I don't know if you can see me.
Nice. Gang Deep, these fans are size 120 millimeter, right?
Yeah, these are 120s. Everyone's waiting for the 140s, myself included. I think I haven't talked to Leanne Lee about 140s yet, but the word on the street, the rumor rather on the street, is that they're in production.
And speed up. I'm glad your grandma can finish a build. Quick, but you know, we're not here trying to do it quick. We're just hanging out. We're just having fun.
Honestly, if I wanted to do this quick, I wouldn't do this on stream at all.
I know, right?
I wouldn't be talking to you people. I wouldn't be trying to do this in a cramped space like this. I would ignore everybody and just do my thing.
Rick Elder says there is a company that makes a custom vented front panel for the regular O11 Dynamic, but pricey at $80. But they think they might also make one for the Mini. I don't know what. Yeah.
I don't know if I would do it, just because I feel like the point of this case is that you're showing off a very beautiful
water-cooled or partially water-cooled to some degree, whether that's through or liquid-cooled PC. But it's cool that people are getting, like, making options like that for others, you know? Like, I've seen some super cool custom panels for the NZXT H1, and I've seen some really cool custom panels for, I think, the NR200, too.
In Gangdeep, the SK Hynix drive that is currently mounted in there is PCIe 3, Gen 3. Gordon says he would love to know the profit margins on RGB fans. King says, can a gray power supply explode? I'm so scared for my brother. He has one of those no-named power supplies.
I don't know. Let's ask Gordon.
Yeah. Gordon probably has the most experience with that kind of stuff. I tell you what, I would not trust my parts with anything that isn't at least 80 plus bronze. Unless you just just really scrimping a budget. But
there's some controversy over that too, because it's like, I mean, rightly so, but, you know, some people say that, like, the certification process isn't uniform enough for it to really count for as much as people give it. That's why there's that list. I think it's a Linus Tech Tips forum list that gets maintained of, like, what is actually considered to be a good power supply. Yeah, because going on the brown or the 80 plus certification alone isn't...
Yeah.
Isn't always enough.
And to be fair, I have had bronze power supplies go out. So, you know, it's not like it means it's going to be perfect. But at I feel like the chances are, though, are a little bit better. You know? Yeah.
Man, I do like these chrome accents. They're pretty.
Sergio, do we know when they are going to release the RX 6000 series of GPUs? Well, technically, it has been released. You just can't buy them.
I think maybe the question is...
I'm lucky if you can.
I feel like the question maybe is more of when do we think that they're actually going to be in more regular stock?
Yes, that's a little bit more
Should I give a spoiler to what I am going to include in my predictions for next week's Full Nerd? Mm-hmm, or should I hold it?
Mm-hmm. Hold on to it.
So I just wanted to be clear. I was willing to tell you, but Adam is making me make you watch next week's Full Nerd.
Yes. It'll be a good episode for a lot of reasons. let's see. I had something. Nick was wondering, looking back, how many white builds versus black builds have we done? I mean, I would probably guess most of them are black.
Of them are black. There's one. Yeah. That's actually a reason why I picked a white case, because I wanted to try to spread out the color, like, arrangement a bit.
Yeah.
I honestly wish more case makers. I mean, I know why they can't, because you have to mass produce them, but I kind of wish that there were more color options. I would love like a powder blue case. I think that'd be super pretty.
Ooh. Yeah, I think it was a friend of the show, Ziv, says we need more pink cases, for sure. Blue Collar Tech's asking, is this build going to be all SSDs, or are we going to throw in a spinning platter drive as well?
I was thinking of picking one up, actually. I didn't list it because we didn't have it on hand, but I'm thinking of making another run, maybe, to grab, 6 terabyte, 8 terabyte hard disk drive to pop into the hard drive cage. Because I mean, as I flip this around towards the back, you'll see that there is room for 2 3.5 inch drives. So one difference I thought I would just point out, because the reason I asked for a 3-pack and individuals, is that the 3-pack only comes with one cable. The individuals each come with a cable. So if you buy 3 different individual UniFans, you'll get the cable with each of them. But if you buy a 3-pack, you only get one, but it also comes with a controller.
Rick says, looking at these fans, it really makes them want to swap out their Be Quiets for these Unis.
But to be quiet means that you're concerned about noise. So I don't know how loud these are. I did not review them.
So Ziff we'll says see. You could just slap some Fantex. And it's scrolled by. Fantex halos on the Be Quiet for RGB. There you go.
Oh, you know, that's right. I always forget that Fantex has some really great accessories. They showed me some of them at CES, but I haven't had a chance to really dive into their product line this year.
DJ 915 thinks cases are so boring, they all look the same, nobody has any creativity.
I would say that that's kind of true for like the mid-tower / compact mid-tower section of the spectrum. They're starting to look pretty similar. It's kind of like how car manufacturers all kind of come out with a similar looking car. You know what I mean?
I mean, there's only so much you can do. I mean, I have that problem on smartphones. Like, I everything's just a black slab.
Sure, but what I mean is that, like, you'll see more innovation. All this to say is that you'll see more innovation in, like, other spaces. So, like, small form factor in particular is, you know, getting a little bit more love and variety. And I think even, I mean, there's not as many these days, but, like, full towers as well tend to look a little more distinctly different.
excuse me, Zemek says kind of a sad story. The PC they bought a week ago has a RTX 3070, and the display ports feel loose, and the monitor is cut out by moving the case just slightly. I contacted the store, and they will replace the whole system. That's a bummer. I'm sorry. That's a bummer.
I missed that. Sorry. What happened?
they got a pre-built system with an RTX 3070, and the display ports on the card are loose, so it's cutting out.
Oh no.
Yeah, the feed
That's
is cutting out.
That's disappointing.
So. Yeah, it's a bummer. That's a bummer. Excuse me. I'm good, thanks. They side is saying, I'm pulling the switcheroo with my SL120s. I bought them from a scalper initially, then got another identical set to return to Amazon to get my money back, so I pay MSRP in the end.
Not entirely ethical, but okay.
King says, is it true that an air cooler will always be better than a cheap liquid one? I think the liquid ones are good from 150 euros and up.
I really think it depends what air cooler you're pitting against the liquid cooler. If you're pitting like a high end, like a Noctua against like the D15 against a low end CLC, then yeah, of course you're going to get great performance out of the air cooler. But if you're comparing like to like, I think that gets a little bit more narrow. Like you can't
I
get a good liquid cooler for under.
Install.
I would say you can get a decent liquid cooler for under 150.
VC Jester gave us $5. Thank you, sir. Always appreciated. Said, what's more important, RGB or performance?
Yes.
And CMC Knight kind of follows up and says, who cares if all cases look the same if they work? Who cares if all cases look the same if they work properly? I'd rather have good temperatures in a boring case than bad temperatures in a funky case. I'm not fully on board with that. I'm not like a performance beats all kind of thing.
I don't disagree with that statement. Yeah. Like, I honestly agree that I think that within a certain set of parameters, as long as the cases should kind of fit that first, and then if you want to get like a little bit fancy with looks, or you know, honestly, I actually really like the Corsair 4000D series, and I guess 4000 series because the D and the X are part of the same series. I like it because I think it's clever of them, because in terms of manufacturing, it's got to be a lot easier. But I also think it's great flexibility for the consumer that the front panel is basically interchangeable. So if you really wanted to, in theory, you could buy a 4000X with a tempered glass front, you know, get some of that, those features, that look, the fans. And then if you decided you didn't like it, you could always swap out that front panel later for an airflow version of the panel. I like things like that. And that's, and it, you know, gives people the freedom to mess around with it a little bit.
Gordon has a great case idea. He's a build idea. He's making an all RGB glass case with no airflow. He's calling it the no flow case. And it said no dust either.
It sounds exactly like a Gordon idea, especially the name. This classic Gordon. I love it.
Paul Collins says all fans, no flow. Oh god, that would be funny. Antoning Unifex says replace their Novatech no brand case of 10 years old with a Lian Li Land Cool 2 mesh a week ago and never going back. Functionality just blew their mind. Super cool. I'm not familiar with that case. Yeah, some people talking about air versus liquid cooling. Elena, have you had any experience with the Silentium PC case?
Is it Silentium?
Silentium, okay.
I do not have any experience with that.
The side is making fun of the H510, saying, hey, is Gordon stealing their idea for the no-flow case? I will tell you what, if you watch the streams I've been doing on this gaming build that I have the H510 Elite here. A lot of people have been yelling about thermals, and I tell you what, it's not been that bad. When I took the side panel off, I got a 3-degree drop, so theoretically, I probably saw a little bit more performance, but for all the yelling people were doing about this case, I don't think it's that bad.
64-bit... Go ahead.
I was just going to say, 64-bit goodness gave us $5. Thank you so much. Really appreciated. Said the Unifan 3-pack comes with individual cables as well.
For each of the fans?
I don't know. They say Elena's must be non-retail.
I mean, I did get it directly from Lian Li, and it was an earlier sample, so it is possible that they changed what went in the box.
Yeah, I wonder if in the box it's literally just a packing of 3 separate ones.
I mean, I don't know how they did it for retail.
Yeah,
but the package I have only comes with the one, and it comes with the controller as well.
I think we have a name for this PC, Elena. A couple people are calling it the Oreo PC.
Oh, I like it. That's cute.
Yeah, let's call it the Oreo. I like it. VC Jester, and yes, they are technically vegan. VC Jester said, Gamers Nexus reviewed a case with 12 RGB fans that didn't blow air anywhere. But at least it looked cool.
Did they call that one the Inferno?
I'm not quite sure which one he's talking about. Man, a lot of good chatter today. I'm having a hard time keeping up. Everyone's got some good things to say. Gabrielle's says, it's sad because this came up in my recommended, and it reminded me of my uncle that told me last year he would buy me a PC. I miss him every day. I want to pursue content creation and gaming, but it's hard.
Sorry for your loss.
They're on a 2011 Mac.
Sorry for your loss. It's been a rough year.
Yeah, but it has been a rough year, and you know, you're doing what you can on a 2011 Mac. Props to you. I'd say getting longevity out of any system is always a delicate act to do what you can while you're waiting for new hardware. So yeah, we feel for you. We definitely feel for you. I feel lucky to be able to play with all the hardware we do. So excuse me. And CMC Knight, yes, that is my official review of the NZXT H510 Elite.
All right, I think I'm going to actually install the radiator before I do the top fans. I'm just trying to figure out how much clearance I have.
Friedheim says we could also call this a Stormtrooper PC.
I'm not a big enough Star Wars fan for that. I was actually just telling a group of friends that my ability to love Star Wars is forever neutered. It's not possible because I started with the prequel trilogy.
It is true. It is true.
My quote unquote friend at the time said that it was the way to do it. I don't recommend you do that if you want your friend to like Star Wars.
Let's see. And Ziv makes a good point, you know, talking about the airflow in a case and performance. Says performance often is just a number in a benchmark. True, you know, it depends on your use case, that's for sure. And Clayman makes a good point. Looks are what the PC community thrives on. It is, I mean, we actually do have in our Discord a channel for showing off your rig, so definitely plenty of people who care about the looks of their PC. Matthew Geyer says you are installing top fans the wrong way for the O11 Mini top 3 to exhaust with rear exhaust and all others inlet.
I had it as an exhaust, so I'm not sure why they're saying that.
Yep. Not sure. Eskimonster's wondering what the radiator that you're using, the CLC.
Sorry, what?
What CLC are you using and why'd you pick that one?
So this is a Lian Li Galahad. It's a 240mm size. I picked this because I already had so much Lian Li hardware for this build that I decided to make it an AMD cross Lian Li build.
Nice. There you go.
Just trying to decide, do I want, for aesthetics, do I want to have the radiators just naked on this side? Do I want to have an intake?
CMC Knight's asking if we've been watching the current season of Star Trek Discovery. I have not.
Nope, Elena, so no spoilers, watched? Please.
No spoilers. I think we're getting into some Star Wars versus Star Trek debate a little bit here.
I think, because this is the radiator, I don't really have to worry so much about. Yes, I'm going to go for aesthetics with this.
Vignesh is asking, have we seen Star Trek Lower Decks? I don't even know what that is.
It's about the junior officers, right?
I guess the name would imply that. I have not seen anything about that.
Just basically imagine this Next Generation episode of Ashley Judd, but more interesting.
And Leo Worker, when will we see game tests on this thing? Well, first we have to build it. Today is just half of the stream. We will be picking up with the other half later. And then we're hopefully going to be doing some testing for a follow-up video. So we're looking more into the new year for that kind of stuff. Ziv is thinking bottom intakes, side intake, rear exhaust, and one top rear exhaust would be great.
Sorry, positive one more pressure, time? Good airflow. I wasn't listening.
Bottom intake, side intake, rear exhaust, and one top rear exhaust.
I honestly feel like the radiator, so this is my opinion, based on stuff that I've looked at, but I kind of feel like whatever fans you're using with a rad don't really contribute to the case's airflow as much as the actual, like, you know, case fans. So at this point, I think I actually might put the fans on the inside of the case, so I'm basically technically exhausting, but that's mostly for aesthetics, given the RGB.
Mm-hmm. Also, you do have a couple people asking for you to have the tubes going down to the CPU, or Steve will.
Yeah. Oh yes, don't worry. I watched that Steve video.
Let's see.
Where is my manual?
Vignesh followed up, said Star Trek Lower Decks is the animated series about the lower ranking officers. Huh. Yeah, I had no idea they existed. Is that one of those you have to have CBS All Access to get? Because I do not have it.
My goodness.
Anthony says, just twist the tubes and mount it sideways. That's a good idea. I like that. Yeah, at this point, it might even be fun to just poke the bear, you know? Maybe if we could see if Steve,
you know what we should do for an April Fool's yeah. build? Is to do everything wrong on purpose.
Yep. Oh my god, people would be so angry in April Fool's build.
Oh my god, that would be amazing. People would be so upset.
Clayman says there's a distinct lack of food check going on here. Good point. Good point.
What happens when you don't have Dennis here?
I know, right? And yeah, maybe I'm a little too hungry. I feel like if I start talking about food, I'm just gonna need to start eating. I wish I had more of those pretzels that VC Jester sent over.
You can order them online.
Zip has a question, food question. What do you eat for breakfast on Christmas holidays? I don't know. Yeah, what did we eat for Christmas holidays breakfast? Oh, you're right. Yeah. Yep. That's what it is. Yeah. So my family, I usually spend it with my parents. I'm not going to be doing it this year, unfortunately, which is a bummer. But yeah, the Christmas Eve, her tradition is always to do crab legs. So we get a ton of really big crab legs, eat it up, and get full on those. And then Christmas morning, she will make a crab leg Benedict.
Oh, that sounds amazing.
Like, eggs Benedict with crab legs in it, with the leftover crab legs, and oh boy. Oh, now I'm hungry.
Why is this so difficult? I don't understand.
Let's see. Yeah, Gordon is helping somebody with their postcodes. CMC Knight says Christmas breakfast is smoked salmon on wheaten bread with scrambled eggs. That sounds pretty good. Clayman says Christmas cake in a cereal bowl. Okay, yeah, you do you. And let's see, I guess some people are talking about buying a 3090 to play Fortnite. That sounds like a good idea. Oh, Rick Elder says a 3090 with Stardew Valley. Great pairing. And yes, David, there are usually leftover crab legs because we will get a lot of crab legs. So we usually eat till we literally can't eat anymore, and then whatever's left over, we crack open and yeah.
All right, I'm having trouble getting this bracket on, and I don't know why.
Let's see. Yeah, I'm coming over to CMC Knight's house.
Oh, good grief. Getting that off is gonna suck. Apparently, once you decide to go AM4, you've committed.
Oh, interesting. Excuse me.
Oh, my goodness. I don't understand. The Intel one is so easy to slide in and out, and this one is definitely not. Now I've... Oh, no.
Rick says that was a loud pop.
Yeah. I think I also, oh no, I cracked the plastic a little.
Uh-oh.
That's sad.
And you're always so cautious with that stuff.
I know, but this one was really difficult to get on. Yeah. Oh, I'm sad now. I never do this.
Triforce Gamer said, what happened?
Well, I was having trouble. So there's like, the way that works is that you have to... My goodness, you have to slide the, so this is the Intel bracket, so this is the pump, you have to, like, it goes like this, right? And so I had to put the AM4 one in, but it was like, so there's like an indentation right here. Oh, sorry, I gotta put it this camera. There's like an indentation right here. And on the AM4 bracket I have, it just wouldn't go past this bump. And so I used my palm of my hand, and I pushed and I cracked the pump a little bit as I did that, apparently.
Let's see. Ruru2's asking, is the Intel 10 850K the best value these days? Great question. Nepripoki says an RX 580 8GB with an i7-9700OK. Define OK, please. I mean, you can game on it. That's probably a good solid 1080p card. Defining OK for sure. DJ915 says, sounds like maybe you could let Lee and Lee know so they can fix it.
I'll ask them for sure, but I don't know if it was just me.
Maybe.
I popped the plastic back, so at least it's, I'll show y'all. Oh, I'm so sad. But yeah, you can see a crack right there now. Maybe y'all can see that. But at least I popped it back so it's flush. But, bummer. I've never had this happen before.
Oh, man.
Sad.
Let's see. Eskimonster says they just built a 10600K system for their son to pair with a 1080. Man, that's a solid system. That's awesome. Love being able to get kids involved in the PC early. I'm bummed I never did. Okay, so Neproki says they have an 8100, an i3-8100, with a RX 580 8GB, and they don't know if they should wait or upgrade to a 9700K from an 8100. I'm assuming you're gaming at 1080p. I'm assuming you're not doing high refresh rate gaming. So if you can expand on that just a little bit, your gaming parameters. And Ziv says he thinks that you are cursed with AIOs, Elena.
I actually really hate installing AIOs. The only one so far that I haven't hated installing is the Kraken. Like, honestly, NZXT's system for installing is really low stress. But it still doesn't take away the fact that you have to, like, precariously perch things. I'm just not convinced I'm going to like this configuration. Like, the tubes are a little... I don't want to say short, but I'm wondering if I'm really going to have enough clearance for my graphics card underneath that little bridge there, that arch.
Yeah, that is weird. Steelskin is asking, can the logo on the cooler be rotated?
It can. That was one of the big things they were touting at CES. I'm just trying to remember how to do it.
Give me 1 second. I'm going to step away for a second, use the restroom, grab a drink of water.
And they also have a little magnet plate, so you can put it on top of the logo here. So it, if you don't want to fly your flag for Lian Li specifically, you can cover that up. I'm a little worried because am I gonna have enough clearance? I can move the radiator to the top. But then I'd have to make this intake. And I don't think this supports 360. I think this is up to 280 only. So I'd have to go down to only two fans. Yeah, this is only up to 280. So I'd have to go down to two fans on the side here. Or I can commit sacrilege and top mount, or put the tubes at the top. Ooh, decisions. Maybe it won't be so bad. Well, we'll find out. Ruru 2, I actually thought, or sorry, Ruru, yeah, Ruru 2, I thought that the issue was that if you had the tubes, the highest most part, point of the tubes higher than the pump, that's the problem. Because that creates the issue of air bubbles forming. Do I dare do it? You know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna cheat this. So I'm gonna install it like this. I'm not gonna put paste on just yet. I'll redo it in case I have to move it once we get to the GPU part, because the GPU is elsewhere buried and I don't want to go get it. And yeah. So if you tune into part two, don't laugh if I forget to leave myself a good note about the lack of thermal paste.
Okay, sorry, I'm back.
I have just told chat that what I'm going to do is basically fake putting on the radiator for now in this position, just to see how it lays out. And then if it works out, I'll just take the pump off, put some paste down, and actually, you know, mount it. Like, I mean, it's mounted, but it'll be like mounted with actual proper thermal paste. Basically like blocking it out, you know? And then if it doesn't work out, then I can move things around. I don't have to worry about taking off thermal paste and putting it back on.
Okay, yeah. No, I like that.
I just told them, if you tune into part two, it's going to be funny, quote-unquote funny, if I forget to leave myself a good note about that. So, where are the... This is what I need. AM4 build, let's see. I need part H and I need part J. It's all this. This is okay.
Okay, I'm back. Let's see.
So one of the other reasons why I don't do speed builds is because I actually enjoy this process of like blocking things out, rearranging them, getting it just the way I like, you know?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
It reminds me a little bit of sewing. I'm not sure if anyone has experience with it, but a lot of times like it saves you much more frustration in the end if you go slower and you like do a mock-up or at least like base the seams to get a sense of how it fits, because then you can like tear that out really easily, and then when you do the actual stitches it's not as much of a problem, because tearing out actual stitches, because they're so much tinier, takes a lot longer. So I enjoy the process of it going this way.
Somebody says you should put a sticky note if you can right on.
Oh, that's a smart idea. I was going to leave myself a digital note, but the sticky note right on the case is way better.
Yeah, right on the case.
Let's go analog for this one.
Yeah, wherever there's room to just put that little sticky note on there. we'll have to remember that for next time for damn sure. Boria Zero likes the idea of you building a sewing machine PC.
Oh god, please don't make me. Oh, I don't even need these. Just need that. I only need two of them. Whoa.
Let's see. Sorry, I distracted. I'm setting up the kitty cam. I have not installed this
lot. Kitty cam. Capture kitty cam.
Yeah. Hopefully my audio or video doesn't freak out while I'm installing this driver for the webcam. Let me switch over to Discord. Oh, nope. Yeah, it's already trying to say, hey, do you want to switch over? No, I do not want to switch over.
So it's interesting because Eminog on Twitch is saying that, I guess maybe in response to me saying it doesn't matter where I place the fans, or maybe they're responding to somebody else in chat. It's hard to see. Hold on. I'm going to lose that chat in a second. Everyone's talking so much. It's great.
I know, right?
They're saying that the fans in front with the rad behind the airflow CFM is reduced. It's more about pushing air across the motherboard and supplying air to the GPU. Air is being drawn into and through the rad. I mean, it's a valid point to make. I just don't think from what I've seen, and maybe we're saying the same thing, and I'm just not processing well because I haven't had lunch since already 1:30. Oh man, we've been almost 3 hours. We've got to end soon. I mean, everything I've looked into, the difference of where you put the fan on the radiator, whether it's for intake or exhaust, doesn't materially affect the cooling, like to a huge degree. I think what matters more is where you actually place it in the case, if I remember right. But I'm not going for perfection with this. I'm going for aesthetics as much as anything else. So it changes a little bit of where everything goes and how it, because I have the concern about how it looks. Okay, install the AMD clips on both sides of the AMD rack and then place the screws on. Make sure to keep the screws slightly loose before placing the water block onto the CPU.
We got some people talking about an i9-10900K build. We should do. We've been doing a lot of AMD lately. I do want to try out some of the newer.
Yeah, I'm glad I'm doing a dry run on this because this doesn't make any sense to me. So I think I'm gonna finish installing the radiator and maybe screw in the fans, and then we'll call it a day.
Okay. And Triforce Gamer is asking what GPU we're using. We have a 6800 XT. It's the Asus TUF edition. So that's what we'll be putting in this in part two.
Yeah.
And yeah, Steelskin makes a good point. If the Ryzen 5000 CPUs are always out of stock, it literally means the Intel chips are the best CPUs money can buy. So can't get them, you get what you can. Gordon says 10850Ks are 430. Frank PDX 42 says my son is starting graduate school, and we're going to build a new PC. Oh, that sounds fun. I love it. I told him March for 5000 series availability. Do you think that's realistic? Well, I don't know about when it's like just readily available for anyone to buy, but I mean, as I saw yesterday, they do pop up if you're diligent to follow notification alerts. It does seem like they are coming in. You just have to be kind of lucky to grab one. I feel like if you're diligent about it, you can probably snag one before March. But you kind of have to be on it and ready to buy it at the drop of a hat, for sure. So.
All right. Sorry, the view is not going to be great for a short little bit as I screw this in. Unfortunately, I don't have like a direct on view yet.
Nice. Also, someday. I'm going to switch over to the kitty cam.
Yeah.
BB's in front of the. Lindsay gave her a little catnip, and she's right in front of the fireplace. So let me. I think this is the correct one. Nope, not doing anything. How about that? There we go. Oh, and it's flipped. Why is it flipped? Let me switch to full HD. There we go.
Kitty!
Stupid watermark. Sorry, I'm using the Logitech capture stuff, and they always put this stupid watermark on it. There we go. Let me turn that off. How do I flip it? No, Phoebe. Oh, she's just floppy. Let's see if I can. Maybe...
Oh, she's a catnip cat.
Oh yeah. Oh yeah, she is. Let me turn on advanced settings. Oh, that's weird. It's flipped in Discord.
Oh. All
right. I forgot. I should put my fans on first. Oh, I'm so hungry.
Oh, exposure. Here we go. Oh, BB. Oh, she's so floppy. So
can we just,
floppy.
Wait, no offense to you, Adam, but can we just always have BB cam?
Yeah. I got no problems with that. This is the content I came here for. And this is a real fire. This is a gas fireplace. We've been using it plenty. If you can see, so I'm going to move the microphone. This little corner right here you see at the bottom is actually the corner of my desk. BB. So the fireplace is right by my desk. Yeah.
So, oh my god, yeah, she looks so tripped out.
Yeah, so she just loves sitting in front of the fireplace. She literally just melts into a puddle and we're like, "Are you okay? Are you okay?" And we just feel her fur, and it's nice and toasty. So, yep.
Oh, Triforce Gamers, I see you. Thank you for the shirt. A compliment.
It is a great shirt. Yeah. So we'll keep it on BB Cam for a little bit. She's so beautiful.
Sorry, I'm working off the stream for a second because I get better leverage. Right here.
No worries.
No one can watch the cat anyway.
I wouldn't call this BB's first official stream. I mean, she's been on plenty of streams, but not like this. Not like BB
gone wild.
Oh wait, Anthony says my cat likes to rest on top of their PS4. Wow. I mean,
it's
PS4.
Warm.
It can run hot. Yeah, I've never had BB try to lay on it. I guess it's kind of in a weird spot too. So that's why she probably wouldn't want to do it, but that's funny. My computer isn't right next to the fireplace. I have room to it. I just mean my desk is close to it. The computers are not like right by it. The obligatory OnlyFans jokes. No, BB's high class. Yeah, very classy. And Cyberwolf 74 is talking about something that a lot of people are talking about. They're seriously thinking of buying a pre-built just to get the GPU out of it. There is a way to do it.
I read an article about that.
Yeah. Wasn't that it was also the case during the mining craze, right? Too.
Yep.
A lot of people were just buying.
Yep.
Pre-builds.
Yep. Because it was such a terrible time to actually do your own.
Yep. So yeah, lots of demand. OK2Go says, off topic, my favorite. So since you're in California, what do you think about California's e-waste fee? And where do people take old PCs to dispose of e-waste? I'll say, luckily our work has its own e-waste drop-off. So as of right now, if I have e-waste, I just drop it off at work. Because the facilities manager takes care of that. Which means also then I don't have to worry about the fee, because our company worries about the fee there. So,
yeah, I don't mind it. Like I find it, you know, just part of being a responsible tech owner.
Yeah, but The Zide says they wouldn't go as far to getting a new GPU just to get the or buying a pre-built just to get a new GPU. They would rather get hooked into Discord or some sort of notification bot that watches restocks to be able to get one, hopefully quick and easy. I mean, yeah, there's always a chance out there.
Splat, chill, I'm coming.
Uh oh.
It's like trying to tear off my doorknob.
When it wants food, it wants food.
It's not even food. Like, half the time he's like, oh, I wanted to see what you're doing back there. Oh, it's nothing interesting. I'll be on my way now.
That's funny.
Cats, I tell ya.
We have a question from Gang Deep. Is there a Lian Li case that comes with fans? Are there any Lian Li cases that come pre-installed?
Land Cool
with
2, the one that the mesh one that everyone really likes.
Uh-huh.
I believe it comes with the 200 millimeter fans. Oh, Splat.
Oh, well. Okay. Let's do that. Okay. Sorry. Just had to delete somebody. And it's... Okay, so for future reference, thank you. It's Thiazide. 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 Sorry. Screwing up names is what I do, so sorry about that. Yep. And Chris confirms the LAN Cool 2 mesh RGB version comes with 3 120 RGB fans. Non-mesh has 2 140s.
Oh, which is the one that had the 200 millimeter fans?
Mm-hmm.
I'll look that up. I have not had a chance to look at all of Lian Li's cases from this year.
Oh, and Cyberwolf says their nephew decided to build his own PC, and I guess they bought the parts before going over the part list with them. So sounds like maybe they got screwed over or something.
Or maybe they bought the wrong motherboard for their processor or something. Oh. That happens.
CMC Knight clarifies the Lian Li 215 comes with 200 millimeter fans.
Okay.
Giovanni says, is a 600 watt power supply sufficient given the power spikes found in testing with the 6800 XT and the 6900 XT? They are recommending 850 watts in New Zealand, I assume. Yeah, I think 600 watts is probably too low.
For what?
For a 6800 or 6900 XT.
Well, those are lower. Wait, what's the power supply?
The 600 watt. They don't say which CPU they're pairing with the 6900 XT, but.
Well, I'm skirting that myself with this build, to be honest. I'm surprised no one's actually mentioned it yet. I guess because I haven't installed the power supply yet. But I'm using a 600 power supply because I could not find anything. I could not find a 750 for small form factor, like it for Corsair. It's just all sold out. Oh my god.
Actually, ooh.
If you're running a 6900 XT, I wouldn't do it. I am definitely skirting the boundary here with the 6800 XT. It helps that I'm using a 5600X, honestly. But yeah, depending on, like you just said, Adam, depending on what CPU you choose, that'll also influence whether or not you'll be able to use that power supply long term.
Also, now that I think about it, I think we do have a larger power supply from Silverstone, small form factor.
Yeah, but it's not going to be compatible with the braided sleeves, braided cables.
Oh, got it.
The individual sleeved cables. That's like, as I said at the beginning of the stream, that was the whole reason I went with Corsair, because I didn't I didn't have to worry because I already had the set in the office from the Viva Las Vegas build from 2 years ago. And I reached out to Corsair and I was like, hey, this is compatible, right? And they're like, yeah. It just might be a little hard for me to make all the cables fit at the back, but we'll see. To buy the cable mod stuff, I just didn't have enough time to get it shipped to work with the Silverstone power supplies.
As we can see, BB has started to scoot away from the fire because as she sticks around for too long, she just slowly starts inching away from it.
It's kind of adorable.
And then over time, she will start inching back towards it. So, this is what BB does all day. When she's not screaming for food, she's usually sitting in front of the fire. Clayman's asking, what's your worst PC blunder?
I just cracked the Galahad.
I'm trying to think. I don't know what my worst blunder would be. I mean, I've done some dumb stuff. Cyberwolf was also recounting the problem that their nephew went through because they had bought parts to build a PC without consulting with them beforehand. So
oh no.
That is a bummer. Sounds like a lot of problems.
I was not paying attention to which track I was using. But that's still not my worst blunder.
And Al Bundy, yes, this is a real fireplace. It is a gas fireplace, though. Not burning logs in here. Yes, Twitch chat matters too. Let me go back over there. Sorry about that. Let's see. Pat and Steel, good to have you. What heads am I using? This is the EMU Teak. So EMU Teak. Very comfortable, very, very comfortable. I like it a lot and stylish.
Oh my goodness.
We got some people talking about gaming over on, or gaming audio over on Twitch. I love it.
I cannot see.
What do I think of the Sennheiser 560S? Let me Google that because I cannot keep things straight in my head. So the HD 560S looks like a pretty nice pair of cans. Let's see, are these open back, closed back? I have always been, and I've always talked about it, Sennheiser has always complimented my ears. The high-end pair I have is a HD 700. I love open back Sennheisers. They're just, oh man, I love them. Sounds like this 560S is pretty cool. I do not have experience with them specifically, but so they are open back. Yeah, that's awesome. Yeah, these look like nice cans. I wish I could get a newer pair of Sennheisers in. I like it. Oh, and yeah, Kate prefers closed back for better bass. I can see that for sure. It depends on what you're looking for. CMC Knight over back on YouTube asking, have I seen the Civga headphones? Let me see. I have not seen these. Dang, those look pretty cool. I like the look of them.
For the love of God.
Wow. No, I've not heard anything about these headphones. I should look into that. That's pretty cool. Thank you for the heads up, CMC Knight. Let's see. CPU, back to blunders, PC building blunders. CPUY says they bent pins on a TZ77A. Went on to buy a second one. I'm assuming that's the CPU where they bent pins.
What are you doing down there, cat?
Oh, it's a motherboard. Nope. Let's see. Talking about the power supply expectations for a 6800 XT. Giovanni says it can run stable on a 600 watt. But there might be some power draw spikes. So, we'll see. We will see. Have I used the Beyer Dynamic DT990 Pro? To tell you the truth, Beyer Dynamic has been on the opposite end of Sennheiser for me. The headphones I've used of Beyer Dynamic have not complemented my ears very well. So I'm not saying that they're bad. I'm sure they're really nice, but it just when I'm looking for reference quality audio, you know, that is one of the things you have to look for, or cans that fit well with the sonic ability of your ears. So, but I mean, these do look nice. I do like the cloth padding on those cups. Those are pretty nice. Got a lot of YouTube or a lot of laptop talk over on YouTube. People talking about upgradability with laptops and whatnot. Getting the most out of them and trying to figure out ways to reduce on e-waste. CPUY, which Bluetooth version are you using? I'm not sure what you're referring to. Bluetooth what? Also, what's BB doing? Is she distracted by something? Oh, she just flopped. Okay. No worries. Well, till BB gets back closer to the fireplace, I'm gonna switch back over to me. Sorry. Sorry, it's just me. And John says Elena needs a McRib sandwich to complete the build. Elena, would you ever use a McRib to celebrate? CMC Knight says the AKGs for them has always fit their ears well, though the HD 599 SD are the first pair of Sennheiser that. Oh yeah, we talked about those, the special edition. I think you got those on the deal, right? You were looking at a good price on those.
Are you talking to me?
Yeah. No, sorry, CMC Knight. Talking about headphones. AKG, I have not used a lot of AKG, but what I have used, it's probably my second pick. If I didn't love Sennheiser so much, I would probably be liking AKG, though their style is a little over the top for me, stylistically. Sometimes the headbands they use are kind of the bridge design or whatever, so not always my favorite. Yep, okay, cool. I'm glad you like them. The Wish MXM. Oh, MXM. David says they wish MXM had really caught on. We talked about that a lot around the Alienware laptop, that one that had the socketable, I think it was a 9800K. And the, I guess that was RTX 20 series, I think. Green Bits is asking you, Elena, why are the AIO cables from the bottom?
Because if I don't, everyone else in chat who's watched Gamers Nexus's video is going to scream bloody murder. That's the cheeky answer. The real answer is that, oh man, I can't believe I did that. The real answer is that, according to Steve's testing, you don't want the top of the tubes to be higher than the pump. And ideally you don't even want this coming out from the side, you want to come out from the bottom, I think, to complete like a circuit so that you don't have to worry about air bubbles forming, which can create It's more of a noise issue than it is a performance issue in this particular scenario. But it can potentially shorten the life of the cooler if you position it in a way that doesn't allow optimal flow. Yeah, okay, there we go.
There we go. Yep, BB's back. She got a little closer, so I've switched back to the kitty cam. The best thing to do on a Wednesday, that's for sure. We got people talking about cars. I guess they're comparing cars to upgradability and recyclability on the CPU side, or the PC side. I'm sorry.
Okay. I definitely have to agree with, I think it was Gamers Nexus in their review of the Galahad, that the mounting system was a little fiddly. It's like, it's not terrible, but it's not my favorite.
Oh yeah, and you can see the little toe beans.
I'm surprised that hers are a different, like, visible color.
Yep, there. She doesn't have any black ones. No mix or anything.
That's interesting. My fella is a gray striped kitty, gray and black, and his are black.
There she goes. She got self-conscious and walked away. People were talking about her toes.
Oh.
Let's see. You're talking about dream cars. This became a car chat. I can only contribute so much to car chat. Not a huge. Yeah, I can contribute a little bit on that, but not a huge car guy.
Yeah, I might have to top mount this because I just don't know if the clearance is gonna work. It's fine. We'll get to it in part two. For now, I'm gonna. Okay. Slap on the top fans and see how it takes, how it looks, and then we're gonna get some lunch because I know Adam's as hungry as I am.
Lunchtime. The tubes do look a bit stretched.
Yeah, but they're not. I'm not really a fan. There's some torque on this outer one that I don't like.
That sucks.
Yeah.
Okay.
Well, all right. I'm just gonna top mount it now because I don't want to leave it like that.
Do it.
I'm surprised. The tubes are actually a little short for my liking on this particular AIO.
No Matthew Lang, I'm sorry. We actually did no ordering food here. For me, I have a rule that I don't order pizza unless I'm building. So I'm not the lucky one today.
And I don't order because I don't have another person to answer the door for me.
There you go. Yep. But thank you for the thought. I do appreciate it. Mahesh Michael says, what's a good CPU to buy? Any recommendations? Well, before anybody can answer that, you probably need to maybe state what you're doing. Is it gaming, content creation? 1080p gaming, 4K gaming. Do you have a GPU you're pairing with it? Are you doing a high refresh rate? What kind of games do you like to play? So a little bit more. Oh, Gordon has a good answer. The one that fits your use case. There we go. Matthew Lang is here.
Happy birthday.
Yep, he said he quote-unquote went podcast style and went to listening on the other monitor. I think a lot of people do that on Full Nerd, where they watch us on YouTube, but they don't necessarily watch us, like, watch the feed. They'll just kind of listen in the background while they do other stuff, so. And Peter Jansen's here, thank you. CPUY is asking what games I'm currently playing. I'm still getting through Cyberpunk. I've streamed it a bunch of times. I'm probably going to stream something tomorrow. I don't know if it's Cyberpunk. I was actually thinking about maybe doing Flight Simulator 2020 since it won the best PC game yesterday on the Full Nerd. But yeah, actually, another game that I've been playing, I was looking through a Game Pass for PC and decided to load up a little bit of the Outer Worlds. Yes, the Outer Worlds. Because I never played it when it came out, and I thought about picking up the Switch version, but man, did that look like a bad port, so I did not do that. So yeah, actually, it's an okay time. I've been digging a little bit. Yeah, Cyberpunk is always cool. And then on the Switch, I mean, every day I log into Animal Crossing. We're still do, Lindsay and I play together, and we still do a ton of stuff on that. And then my mindless kind of game is, somehow I'm actually still playing Immortals Fenyx Rising. I got it on the Switch. Luckily, it has the cross-save compatibility from what I had started on the PC. And that is just like the perfect.
No, I did it again.
It's like the perfect zone out collectathon kind of Ubisoft game that you can expect. So I, yeah, those are kind of the major ones that I've been doing. CMC Knight says, any chance of having Gordon a Gordon hand ringing merch? Man, I don't even know how we would do that.
I mean, it would have to be a cartoon illustration of Gordon doing the hand wringing.
Mm-hmm. That would be interesting.
Maybe in round three.
El Sukov is asking you, Elena, why no top radiator mount?
Because I want to fully populate the top with fans. Just cuz. But the way I envisioned it originally was to have a kind of a bottom to top airflow pattern. Mm-hmm. And that's why I'm doing this radiator on the side here. Well, I'm pretty sure I'm going to get a ton of comments saying like, wait, the Gamers Nexus says.
Nix is asking, do we ever do builds for audio mixing PCs? That is a great question. And I'll tell you what, I started my audio career on Macs. So I have a lot of experience using Macs for audio, but I haven't dug into it as much as I should on the PC side, and I've been really bummed by what is available. Some of the problems I've run into on the PC side with audio production. So that is a bummer. I do want to do something that would be cool, but yeah, it's something I would really want to look into to figure out the best builds for that kind of stuff. Let's see, sorry. Whoa, boy. Wow, lots of chat go by and I missed it. Clayman, yep. Outer Worlds, the draw for that is mostly just the exploration, and I mean it's like a typical Bethesda kind of game. It's nothing groundbreaking, but I do like it better than Fallout. What's that open world, the MMO Fallout? Fallout 76. Yeah, I just could not get into that. And it is beautiful. The art design on it is really nice. So I don't think I'll stick with it, but it has been fun to fire up and explore around. Andrew is asking you, Elena, how come you're mounting the radiator as an intake? I initially mounted mine as an intake in my build, but I found that the chipset would get a bit hot under load.
Purely aesthetics. If I cared more about performance, I would have put the fans on this side instead. Because there's a cutout on the panel so that you can actually get like fresh air for intake. I'm gonna run it this way first and then see how I like the temps, and if they're acceptable, I'll leave it, and if not, then I'll flip it around.
Nice. Rick Elder says the hand wringing merch should be a hand towel. Yes.
That's pretty good. I like that.
Yes, I like that. I like that a lot.
Clever.
Eltsukov is asking you, Elena, do you like gaming?
If my shirt didn't give it away, yes. Yes, I do. I just haven't had as much time for it as of late. It's been a very busy season. I started Valhalla on stream, and I played like another day or so of it, and then I haven't been able to get back to it, so it's been like a month. It sucks.
Wow. I'm really behind on chat here. Sorry about that, you fine folks. Clayman's asking why Fallout guys didn't win best game. Probably because most of us didn't play it as much as Brad did.
I did not like Fall Guys, so it would not have won my vote.
Nope.
And we talked about that on stream yesterday. For me, I like the premise of Fall Guys. I think it's fun. I think it's cute. But I, like, for example, like, if you're playing Mario Kart, I am not a Bowser player. I hate the way he feels. Like, it's just too heavy and slow. Like, I like a very light, responsive kind of feel in my games. And Fall Guys just feels like playing, like, Mario Kart with Bowser. And maybe even a little extra slowness. I'm very much like a Toad, Yoshi, Peach type player.
Interesting. Giovanni's asking, has anyone thought of a lemonade build competition between the channels? Example, take the same worst hardware and try to make the best out of it. So you take badly reviewed hardware and see who can get the best performance out of it. That's an interesting thought. CMC Knight's still asking for a SimCity 4000 stream on the 3400V. I'm not a huge SimCity fan, so you'd probably just see me fumbling and just getting frustrated and not knowing what the hell I'm supposed to be doing there. So, Ziv makes a good point about fan stuff. There's usually no one right way lit. There's usually no one right layout for fans. It comes down to trade-offs. Only wrong layout is to not have enough fans. Well, yeah, well said. I like that. And David makes a really good point. No, there is no wrong way to eat a Reese's.
There is no wrong way, but there is definitely ways that people feel are more optimal than others.
You guys can't see me, but I'm nodding my head.
Peter Jansen, I think that Elena and PC World are willing to admit that PC gaming is better for Cyberpunk 2077. Yes, Cyberpunk 2077 plays the best on PC. I have no problem saying that. Also, Rick Elder's asking you, Elena, did you ever finish Control?
No. Also on my list of things to get to, so I'll probably do some more game streaming during my winter break, which is coming up in like a week, I think. I don't even know what time is anymore. Like, I keep saying I'm gonna go on vacation or I'm gonna take time off, and I was supposed to have yesterday afternoon off, but I ended up having to prep for the build. So that didn't work out, unfortunately, for me.
Ziv says the build is shaping up nicely, easily nicest looking build so far. Wow.
It's pretty. I mean, like, look at these accents. I don't know if you guys can see it in the light. Pretty. The sad thing about doing this all as exhaust, though, is that you get the running it this way means you get the less pretty view from the inside of the fans.
Giovanni has another build suggestion. What about making the noisiest PC we can? I don't know why we wouldn't do that.
Actually really like that. That's basically another way of saying like the cheapest build possible.
Yeah, cheapest with the, like, yeah, with as many fans as possible and the loudest stock cooler, the loudest GPU. That's funny. Actually, you know what? You could probably make sure a couple
flipped.
screws are loose so that the case rattles a little bit somewhere.
Something is wrong. In, out, in, out. Okay, there you go.
Ricardo is asking, are those fancy fans on the same level as top-tier Noctua ones, performance and noise-wise?
I have not looked at the charts yet, but my gut reaction to that would be no. I don't think they're bad, I just don't think, I mean, Noctuas are definitely tuned for performance, not looks.
Definitely. David Wellman's asking, will beige ever make a comeback in PC builds?
I think that's one of those things where, like, when it comes back, it's kind of nice, but I don't think it's anything that people really wanted when it was the actual, like, not trend, but just the only option you had. And I don't think anyone wants it to come back in the way it actually was. I think it would be nice if it came back in the Maximum PC build, as Gordon mentions in chat. Like, one year they did this, like, it was Smooth Creations, and so Smooth Creations basically does, like, the equivalent of a custom car, like, paint job. So you've got, like, the clear coat, and it's, like it's this beautiful, like the tone of the beige is really nice. So it's, like, very, like, subtle and classy looking. So if it was like that, I would be all for it. But, like, my old Dell PC, no, I'm good. That can stay in the past.
I think it'd be interesting to have kind of a beige comeback. I'm not necessarily a fan, but... Yeah. It's kind of like I think it would have been funny if they would have sold a SNES Classic, the smaller version that was already faded yellow. you know, like, hey, do you want the way it was out of the box, or do you want the way it was after it had been aged for a couple years?
I think I just saw a chat message fly by. Sorry, I didn't catch the name. Asking about the AIO cooler position. Yes. According to the testing that was done by Gamers Nexus, you are correct. However, I am choosing... I'm choosing aesthetics. Mostly also because this is not meant to be a long-lived build.
Yeah, I mean, that's the thing. We're not necessarily recommending this is the exact position and the parts that you would use for this build.
Yeah. But I think... I mean, kind of going back to your point, Adam, about the whole NZXT H510 thing. Yeah, it's really good to shoot for the optimal, right? And, like, and I love the work that Gamers Nexus does because, you know, Steve really focuses on, like, the optimal performance of things. Like, how you can squeeze that last percent out. Like, trying to basically get you the most value for whatever money you're spending, in a way, by holding companies to this high standard. At the same time, I think realistically speaking, there is not a material difference, you know, in a couple of degrees between, like, let's say for cases, like if this case you get like a rating of 47 degrees and this one has a rating of 49 degrees, I don't think it means that the second PC case is absolute trash. You know what I mean?
I think with a lot of things, as long as you are armed with the knowledge, if you're willing to at least accept the setbacks, and that there's a trade-off for you, then, you know, I don't think there's any wrong way either on that end. El Tsukov makes a good point. You can always flip the case upside down. There you go.
These builds are not meant to be instructional. These builds are just really about me playing with different configurations, me experimenting with, like, the hardware that I have to get a feel for how it feels to build with it, hanging out with you all, and, you know, seeing where I can make things a little interesting for myself.
Like, you know, casting so much shadow on this side of the case that I can't see where my screws go.
Yeah, I mean, this is kind of a side tangent, but it's something I was talking to with the head of TechHive, our sister site that focuses on smart home type content. And I recently reviewed the Bowers & Wilkins PX7 Carbon Edition. These are some active noise canceling headphones. Pretty nice. Go check out the review. I did dig them. But I was comparing them a lot to the Sony WH-1000 XM4, which is kind of our top pick for the best noise-canceling headphones for most people. Because while these are not that much more expensive, they are more expensive. And the benefits of going with Bowers & Wilkins over the Sony is that these are actually a much more accurate audio listening experience. Whereas the Sonys have coloration, Bose very, very much has coloration on their headsets, and I will be reviewing the Apple headset as well, and I'm curious to see what kind of coloration they have. But what the thing is that somebody who doesn't know audio could put these headphones on and say, "Oh man, that sounds like crap compared to the Sonys," because the Sonys are actually EQ'd and have a sound profile that is going to, we call it like a scoop. It's usually ups the bass, ups the high end, makes it really punchy, puts a little bit more compression on it, and makes it just be like, oh wow, all my music is just sounding so awesome and crisp and clear, and it's got a lot of low end. Where this is more accurate, and you're gonna get a more even listening experience. So some people would be like, oh, it's kind of flat, it's kind of dull. But for somebody like me who actually like wants something that's more accurate, it's definitely worth the money to get that over the Sonys. But the Sonys will probably sound better to more people. Yeah. Anyway, side little tangent just got me on.
All right. I think we've reached a stopping point.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
Oh, this is upside down right now. I guess I'll flip it up right side up. But as you can see, there's a lot of fans in here.
A lot of fans, yeah. Hey, well, we definitely loaded it up with fans. And the front panel is tempered glass, right?
Correct.
Correct. Got it.
So, yes, we have a total of eight fans in here. The O11 Mini does not support 360 here. It's only up to 280. And if the Galahad came in a 280 size, I would have gotten that, but they don't. They only have 240 and 360. So, but I personally would have liked a 280 here just to fill this space out a little bit more. Mm-hmm. But again, this is very much an aesthetically minded build because of the O11 being what it is. So some of it, I mean, I am obviously making some choices here that are not optimal, absolutely optimal for performance. Like if I wanted to really be a little bit more careful about, you know, the AIO's longevity and like following, you know, best practices as established by our peers, I would top mount it, but I like the symmetry of this. I don't know if y'all can see that, but I really enjoy the symmetry between the top and the bottom.
Yeah, that is really nice.
There's a point where I actually used part of the I used the dust filter from the bottom to kind of give myself like a reference point to line them up, you know, because again, aesthetics matter for this build.
Dang. Well, yeah. Does the Galahad have any RGB on it?
Yes. I think if I remember right, it does. Yeah.
So on the fans or the...
The pump, I think, has it too.
Oh, the pump.
But the fans as well.
Nice. Yeah. I think this will be really pretty white case. Load up some
Yeah, the only thing I forgot, quote unquote, is RGB strips. But, I mean, I can always add those later if I really want, but...
Also, there's probably going to be enough.
Probably.
Yeah. Are you going to put, I forgot, are you going to put a fan in the rear?
I will if I feel like I can route that wire in a way that doesn't make me hate my life. I think I can do it. Like, I think... So I configured this case, obviously, for a micro ATX motherboard. And that was mostly because I wanted to make sure I had enough clearance for the fans. I actually think I could have still gone with a full ATX board in this. So I know Corbin was in our chat. And he's been thinking of doing an ATX build. So you might be able to, if you want to go full aesthetics, you might be able to still do this with your full ATX motherboard. But I went with the micro ATX. I kind of wanted to see like my clearances and all that. And I mean, I do have room to... There we go. I do have room to populate this bottom slot still, if I want to, like with maybe like a sound card or a capture card.
And thank you to Rick Elder real quick. Don't forget the note that you need thermal paste.
Yeah, my sticky note. Thank you.
I gotta say, after using the MSI Mag Tomahawk that I have in this video production PC and seeing that mortar, I am liking the looks of the MSI boards.
The look is great. I'm actually more curious to see how, I think it's Mystic Light is MSI's control for RGB, and I feel like it's been 2 years since I did the Viva Las Vegas build, and I don't think that the open source type systems, like not even open source, but at least like motherboard systems where like it's more open than like NZXT Corsair type systems. Mm-hmm. Like their software control isn't super great still. Pretty rudimentary. Yeah. So I'm kind of curious to see how sophisticated MSI's is, because I've only really had experience with Aura, ASUS's Aura Sync.
Hopefully you can get at least a single solid color
Steel skin. I just saw your chat message. I absolutely hate Mystic Light, so that doesn't sound very great for me, but we'll see how it goes. But yeah, thank you all for joining us for this part one. I'm glad we split this into two, because I don't think I could have done this in one go without dying.
Yeah, so what's just to give a preview, what's left to do?
So what's left is dropping in the GPU, the hard drives, you can't even see my fingers. So GPU, hard drives, power supply, not necessarily in that order. And then cable routing. I might cheat because I'm a little worried about time, because cable management, I get really thoughtful and introspective about it. So I might cheat and actually populate the drives and the power supply off cam, just because I want to like not spend too much time on the build next time. And that way, if there's extra time left over, we can always boot this, and then I can start playing with light configurations, and we can end on that note.
True. Yeah, I like it. And question from Rick Elder: do you think the white unifans would look good in the black O11D?
Oh.
What do you think?
I think it would be very striking. I think I would like that personally, but I don't know how other people feel about it. I decided not to do an all white build, just because I didn't know how it was going to bounce the light. But I mean, I think if you wanted maximum RGB effect, and if you did like a mostly all white build, like there are white unifans, there was a white Galahad, then, you know, I kind of wonder how that would look, but I chose black, so it's gonna be a little more subdued.
I like it. The Oreo build, maybe you just blast all white on the fans. There you go.
I think of this as the cookies and cream, because it reminds me of those Hershey cookies and cream bar.
That's a good one. I like it.
But yeah, I think that's where we're doing we don't actually have a time locked in for the next build yet. We're tentatively saying Monday, but our video schedule just got a little like crazy, like abruptly this morning. So tentatively Monday at 11. We will keep you all posted. Keep a lookout on Discord, keep a lookout on my Twitter feed. I'll keep you all in the loop.
Definitely, yeah. Thank you everybody for joining us, and thank you again to SK Hynix for sponsoring this build. Really appreciate it. And yeah, tomorrow, like I said, I will be doing a game stream. I'm not quite sure. Actually, you know what? No live stuff on Friday. So yeah, the next thing after that would be the if we do this build on Monday. But yeah,
Check
on Discord and keep check on Twitter, and we'll do second part of this. So thanks, everybody.
Yeah, I went to black a little too soon. Bye. Oh. Sorry about that, everybody. I forgot that I'm not in preview mode. It's lunchtime. And also, thank you, Lindsay. I just saw your message. I appreciate that. And right. Bye, all.
See you, everybody.
Have a good evening. Bye.